gorgeous afternoon as we look forward to this ball game between the Colorado Buffaloes and their Heisman Trophy winner and the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame in their famous green jerseys today. So stay with us. We'll be back with the ball game after this station identification break. Today is the day Bill McCartney says goodbye, for he can give no more. He has given a football team life. Now he wants his back. Perhaps he has given too much, each success exacting its toll on the man. Winning a national championship.
Number one for Colorado.
Creating a football tradition where there was none before. His player winning the Heisman Trophy for the first time in school history. Even miracles, it seems, have a price. His legacy secure, he has chosen a new direction. He can give no more. He has asked for his life back, and today Bill McCartney and his wife Lynn say farewell. For Notre Dame, today is not an end. Rather, it is a beginning for the future. One that looks promising for the Fighting Irish and Lou Holtz. The Fountain of Youth in South Bend is inspiring dreams of a return to glory after a hard season, one that has forged character. And so today, one coach looks ahead, thinking of seasons to come, while the other reflects back. And so the scene is set here at Sun Devil Stadium. And what a confrontation we have awaiting us this afternoon as we begin the new year. An absolutely gorgeous day. Weather conditions are perfect. 60 degrees, 3 miles an hour, just a little bit of a breeze, the forecast, mostly sunny for the rest of the day. And now we wait for that anticipated moment, and that is, of course, when both teams will come onto the field, and you always try and script this, you try and time it out perfectly, and Ralphie, the third, will also be leading the charge, and are you ready? They're not ready.
Well, this is the bowl game. It's a big game for both teams. I mean, between Colorado with the Heisman Trophy winner, and, you know, honestly, Notre Dame and the Fighting Irish and 6-4-1 record, and Lou Holtz being very defensive about that, the green jerseys, I mean, everything.
And Colorado coming in feeling that they should have somebody with a higher ranking, but Notre Dame is a team that, believe me, that they can certainly get ready for anybody, particularly when Lou Holtz has 2 or 3 weeks to prepare for an opponent. And Ralphie will lead the charge and stay out of her way. Colorado Buffalo. Talk about mounting a charge. She's ready. And the rest of the players are also ready. And next we await the entrance of Notre Dame. Deshaun Salam, the Heisman Trophy winner, an outstanding high school player at La Jolla Country Day. All kinds of records. He scored 112 touchdowns, 8-man football, and he has taken those numbers right to the college ranks.
Coach McCartney, his last game today as a Colorado Buffs head coach, and with that running back, Abdul Salam, Rashan Salam, he is counting on a big, big running game from the Buffalo offense.
We mentioned the green jerseys. Lou Holtz, of course, he has the green cap as he leads the way into the Fiesta Bowl for the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Touch that you might notice is that the balloon man did not get the word on the green jerseys. And the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. And Randy, for Notre Dame, this truly is the new year.
It really is. They prefer to look at this as not the last game of the 94 season, but really the first game of what they think is going to be a special 95. And that whole year is going to be built around what Lou Holtz calls a really good offensive line. First time this line will be starting together today. Their job, protect Ron Paulus, open holes in that defense of Colorado, and give Lee Beckton, their halfback, a chance to pound that defense.
We want to take this moment to welcome the rest of the country that is joining us here at Sun Devil Stadium for the Fiesta Bowl between Notre Dame and Colorado. We just had a look at Notre Dame, and now for Colorado, it is the opposite. Not only the end of the season, but is the end of an era.
It's an end of an era for Coach Mack, for Coach McCartney at Colorado. It may very well be the end of the Rashan Salam era at Colorado coming off the Heisman Trophy, but you really have to concentrate on two people, Salam and also Cordell Stewart, their great quarterback. But Salam is a running back that loves to get out in space, loves that option play, and gets all his big plays out of the option play. His offensive line loves to cut down defenders, look for a lot of helmets down around the knees of the Irish. And in Cordell Stewart, a very underrated quarterback, I think, nationally, a quarterback who can run. He's the fastest guy in the Buffaloes team, and a quarterback that will key that option play. And if the option play works, the play action works for Bill McCartney's offense, and play action means huge plays for the Buffaloes.
All right, let's go down to Dan Hicks.
All right, Charlie, thank you very much. There could not be two more contrasting locker rooms as for Notre Dame and Colorado. Let's start with the Fighting Irish. Lou Holtz has low-keyed this preparation all month long. It played over into the locker room when just a couple of moments ago he talked to the team very low tones. He did address the green jerseys. In fact, Lou Holtz made up his mind 5 weeks ago that this team would wear green jerseys because it displayed the underdog type of season, and deservedly so, that they would get to wear the green jerseys and a chance to knock off Colorado. As for the Buffaloes, well, the seniors, 14 of them, did the same thing. They separated themselves from the rest of the team, went back into the locker room and addressed the rest of the team. The final word, as it is all season long, is love. There's been a lot of love for Bill McCartney in his 13 years at Colorado, and maybe senior Michael Westbrook summed it up the best when he said, you know what, this is the one last chance we all have to be happy together one final time. Charlie?
The wearing of the green for Notre Dame.
This is all the times of late, the times they have worn that green jersey. Psychology is one of Lou Holtz's strong points. This is a team that's been down all year, and he can tell them in that pregame talk, this team has never lost in these green jerseys. We're not going to start it right now, and we're going to get after these Buffaloes physically. Don't look for anything cute out of Notre Dame in this game. They're going right after Colorado.
Notre Dame won the toss. They have deferred, so Colorado will receive. Herschel Troutman, number 26, Lyndon Henry, number 39, are the return men. Scott Sinja will be kicking off for Notre Dame. taken at the 18-yard line by Henry. And he is going to be wrapped up in the neighborhood of the 30 or the 31-yard line. So now let's take a look at Colorado's offensive line. In reality, these are the main men, the five men responsible for Rashan Salam and his more than 2,000 yards. Backs and receivers, the Heisman Trophy winner, Randy, we talk about, but Notre Dame has much more to worry about.
Especially Michael Westbrook out on the outside. He'll be starting opposite today, Ivory Covington, a true freshman at cornerback. You got to take advantage of a size mismatch. Covington at 5'8", Westbrook 6'4".
And he opened with a play-action fake. Throws to the near side to Carruth, and Carruth will be wrapped up at the 37-yard line. So a quick gain of 6. It'll be second down and 4. Let's look at Notre Dame's defense. There's that front 7. They've got multiple problems. You saw one of them there with the pass. They have to stop the run, and they have to stop the option, and they have to pressure the passer. Secondary, well, they have a problem. There's a freshman at cornerback.
And they went right after Ivory Covington, number 14, on that very first play. First play, he got Carruth. This play, he gets Westbrook.
And here's Salam, a straight shot up the middle. And he should pick up the first down. He'll go to the 42-yard line, and he's stopped by Brian McGee. And so Colorado with the first down of the ball game.
Charlie, if there was one group you could say could control this ball game and really just dominate it, would be the offensive line of Colorado. A very strong unit, a very quick moving unit, and a unit that opens huge holes for Salam. If Colorado can run, that sets up their play action, and that bodes very, very bad for Notre Dame.
And here's Salam to the right side. He's around the corner to the 50, cuts back 45-yard line. Back-to-back first downs for the Buffaloes as he picks up 13 yards. Brian McGee again with the stop. Now a little bit of pressure on old number 19, because at the Heisman Trophy Award ceremonies, he stepped out on the ledge and said, I should have more than 150 yards rushing against that defense.
And the reason he is so confident is his offensive line. Watch the line move. Look at Chris Natoli, the right guard, 65, gets that cut block, knocks down Goheen, opens up that outside, and that's what that line does well. It moves out, and he cuts back after their block.
Now Stewart, three-step drop, whistle sound. And we've got some pushing and shoving. Lou Holtz told us to set the tenor for the ball game. He said, I would just love to see my defensive lineman first play, jump off sides, hit everybody, take the 5 yards, and let's go play football. He has them fired up. Here's the call.
Dead ball foul. An offensive man in the neutral zone prior to the snap. 5 yard penalty, first down.
So move the ball back to the 50-yard line, and it'll be first down and 50. An opening drive of the ball game, no score in case you just joined us.
A weapon, Charlie, that Colorado has that Notre Dame's had a hard time with all year has been the tight end. And their main target throwing the ball has been Christian Fourier, number 86, has the speed at 4-5 to get down into the seams of the defense.
Play action fake. He goes deep over the middle, a little behind Michael Westbrook, but he pulls it in. 28 yards, first down. That's Stewart to Westbrook. You will be hearing that call all afternoon.
And of all the Colorado players, he's probably the most excited about this game, Charlie, because this is his first game. He says he's been truly healthy all year long. He's had a problem with his arch in his foot. He's been banged up. And naturally, when a receiver's on a team where a running back gets 2,000 yards, the passing game is going to suffer a little bit.
And it's a first down. Here's Salam. 19-yard line. So he'll pick up 3. It'll be second down and 7.
Now, Colorado under Bill McCartney has been a great team, especially this year in the first quarter. And if you had to pick one key for Notre Dame, that would be limiting that scoring offense in the first quarter, because Notre Dame has started fairly slowly this year. Colorado, on the other hand, gets big leads, attacks with the defense, and just starts pounding with his Salam.
Westbrook in the slot on the left side. And here's Salam. He spins close to the 15-yard line. So he'll pick up about 4 on the play. It's going to be third down and 3.
You know, he's one of those running backs, when you talk about style,
and maybe a little bit of this is reputation, but when he gets the ball, you sort of hold your breath because you're never really quite sure. Because his acceleration, his speed point is not in his first 5 yards. And Bob David, the defensive coordinator of Notre Dame, knows you got to stop him in that first 5 yards because at his speed, he is gone if he gets out in the open.
They set it at the 16, so it's third down and 4. Into the end zone, and it is incomplete. Little deep fade to Westbrook. He overthrows him. It'll be fourth down, and the kicking team will come aboard.
Watch the height differential between these two players, between Covington and Westbrook. Westbrook 6'4", Covington 5'8". I mean, it almost looks like, you know, a high schooler and a junior high schooler out there when you see him matched up. But don't be fooled by the attitude of Covington or the size of Covington, I should say. He is going to attack Westbrook early.
Neil Voskuritsyn with a 33-yard field goal attempt. It is up, and it is good. From 33 yards away, Colorado opening drive. They're on top, 3-0. Back with the kickoff in a moment. Gorgeous. Hey, dear Randy, you gave advice to players, particularly the seniors on both ball clubs, and that was after the game is over today, is linger on the field and enjoy the moment.
Having been through these games in the Rose Bowl, the Super Bowl, games like that, you've just got to do it when you're a senior. You've got to soak all the atmosphere, and you don't know, especially as a senior in college, this may be the last chance they ever have of being on a football field in this type of a situation. Stay down there, relax, soak it in and take it easy.
Neil Voskuritsyn will be kicking off for Colorado. Scott Solman, number 83, is the return man. And it is taken on the far side by Charles Stafford. And Stafford reversing the field near the 45-yard line. An excellent return for Notre Dame. 33 yards on the return. Ryan Black finally makes the tackle, and the Fighting Irish will start with a very good field position. Their offensive line, they're finally healthy. Randy talked about it, and they'll all be back next year. There's a look at them. Their backs and receivers. Their quarterback, he's young, Ron Paulus, but this has been a year of experience.
It really has been. And the key really for Notre Dame is they got to get Becton going. The running game must work today.
And this is what they open with, and that is number 4, Lee Becton off the right side. He's going to pick up 4 or 5 yards on the play as we check out the defense of Colorado. The front 7, led by 2 seniors, Ted Johnson and Darius Holland. And the secondary, well, they've got the Jim Thorpe Award winner at cornerback.
They do. It's a high-quality defensive backfield, high-quality pass defense. And really, honestly, Charlie, I don't think the green jerseys really have any effect on the Colorado defense. If anything else, it helps to pump them up more than anything else.
It's second down. Buffaloes lead by 3. First opportunity on offense for Notre Dame is Lee Becton again. He kind of battles his way through traffic. They're going to mark it at the Colorado 45-yard line. So it will be a first down for Notre Dame, their first of the ball game. Ted Johnson makes the tackle for the Buffaloes.
I talked about the fact the running game has to go. Watch the backside, Clevenger and Quist, 75-69. Push, push, push on that reduced defense in front of them. Nothing fancy, nothing cute. Like I said, they're not going to do anything really remarkable outside of trying to come off the ball. And they've got the message and the mission from Lou Holtz to smack him in the face.
The fullback is Mike Edwards. And Paulus to throw a little swing to Becton behind to pick it up. He has 5, 7, close to 10. He's going to be about a yard shy of the first down. It'll be second and short. And it was Dalton Simmons who stopped him for the Buffaloes.
Nice play calling on that case there by Notre Dame, only because the Colorado defense, Charlie, is so fast. Notre Dame must make their living inside because Lou Holtz knows the speed of the Colorado defense will outflank his Irish offense.
Second down, about a half a yard. Edwards, the first back through, the fullback, and he'll pick it up. He'll get a couple. He'll mark it at the 33-yard line, and a first down for Notre Dame. Dusty Ziegler, the offensive center with the lead block for Notre Dame.
And the biggest contrast here today you're going to see is in the style of offenses. Colorado has that hold your breath kind of mentality where Salam or Westbrook could go all the way. Notre Dame, on the other hand, wants to keep the ball on the ground, wants to keep that clock running, and honestly wants to keep the ball away from Colorado.
Play action fake on first down. Collins has pressure. He's sacked at the 40. Shannon Clavel with 5 sacks during the regular season. The All-Big 8 defensive end has the first sack of the game for Colorado.
Well, that was a sack that happened the way you want it to happen. That collapses the pocket. Paulus goes back to pass, has nowhere to step up to because Clavel's there. The pocket is closing on both sides, and that is why Colorado has started this game. Watch their defensive ends. They're collapsing and they're reducing, and they're giving Notre Dame a different look on the backside with a reduction.
Ray Zellers is now the fullback. He's in the block. Paulus to throw. Pressure backside. Back to backside. 46-yard line. A moment ago, first down at the 33. Now the 2 sacks combining for a loss of 13. Greg Jones gets this one.
Now watch what happened on this defense. It's reduced. The guard's covered. You've got stuff coming from the outside on Paulus. And when it happens, you've got to match up a running back on the linebacker. And that doesn't work. Clevenger can't handle Jones. You're outmanning the Notre Dame offense on that side by bringing one more guy than they can block.
Paulus to throw. Quickly goes to Emmett Mosley. Mosley, the speedster, as he hit him from the wide receiver spot, cutting back inside, he cuts his way to the 30-yard line. He gets a big 16 of it back.
He does. He's going to be the change of pace for Lou Holtz, really, to Charlie, today. He's the guy that's going to be on the reverse pass, the inside screens, because he's got the speed to be a game breaker against Colorado.
Now remember, that was third down and 23. It'll be fourth down and around 7 or 8. Guess what? Notre Dame wants a timeout. We'll talk it over. We'll be back. We're just past the midway point in the first quarter. Colorado leading 3-0. Notre Dame fourth down and 8. They go for it with a 3 wide receiver set. Sideline to Derrick Mays. It is incomplete. First time he has gone to Derrick Mays. And Mays, of course, is a junior. He may declare and go professional. And his quarterback, Ron Paulus, who just threw the ball, said, I want him back. He doesn't like to handle the media. I'll handle the media for him.
Well, Lou knew he was going to go to Mays. I think everybody in Colorado knew they were going to Mays. He is the guy for Notre Dame as the receiver. And look at the coverage he's drawing. You got the man on one side, you got the safety inside help, and, you know, once again, the kicking game comes back to curse Lou Holtz, because a lot of teams would try a field goal from that close, but he doesn't have a kicker that could get it to the letters in the end zone, much less the crossbar.
The kicking game is albatross as Colorado takes over the 30-yard line. Here is the option, Stuart Keach. He's the fastest man on the team. He breaks clean down the sideline and out of bounds at the 41-yard line of Notre Dame. 29 yards, Cordell Stewart. Tatum finally ran him out for the Irish.
Cordell Stewart, 4-3-1, and watch the explosion at the point of the option right there. See that lane created by Naoli and the entire right side of the offensive line? You've got the offensive guards optioning around. They're cut-blocking linebackers, and that opens the seams in Lou Holtz's defense.
The number 2 rusher on the team, almost 640 yards during the regular season. And he's going to throw. Good protection. It's incomplete. He was going to Michael Westbrook. Brian McGee had the coverage. It'll be second down.
This is a perfectly thrown ball countered by an excellent defensive play. Ball low, away. McGee just gets in there and knocks that thing down. That's the kind of play that Notre Dame needs. Notre Dame needs to deny Colorado the possible big play.
Second down. Here's Salam, right side. About 3, that's going to be it. They'll mark it at the 38-yard line. It'll be third down and 7. Lyron Cobbins wrapped him up immediately as we will skip across the country to New York for an update.
Thanks, Charlie. Hannah Storm in New York to tell you about the CarQuest Bowl. South Carolina and West Virginia, this just over in Miami. Steve Tannehill, Gamecocks quarterback, didn't see anybody open. Takes it in himself, ran for a touchdown, passed for one. The Gamecocks win this one 24-21, their first ever bowl victory on their ninth try. Now let's send it back to Tempe.
Third down and 7. Stewart play action fake. Good protection across the middle. Pass is complete. Savoy will not make it. He has stopped at the 1 yard line, 37 yards for Phil Savoy, whose dad, by the way, played in the NFL in 1971 with the then St. Louis Cardinals.
And you're seeing a mismatch size-wise. Not only is Covington mismatched with Westbrook, you got receivers like Savoy matched up on Sean Wooden, who also is only 5'11". And what Cordell Stewart is saying to his big wide receivers is just get out there. I'm going to throw it on the outside, and I know you can reach further than the smaller guy can.
So his first down and goal to go about a yard and a half away. Play action fake to Sinan. The throw all alone in the end zone is Christian Fourier, the tight end from Crespi High School in Los Angeles, the alma mater of my broadcasting partner.
And what a great job Cordell Stewart and Salam did selling that. There's a flag down on the field, but boy, did that Notre Dame defense bite.
Ooh, yes.
We have an unsportsmanlike on the scoring team after the touchdown.
So the touchdown will stand.
And they'll put that one back on the kickoff to kick it back. I mean, they'll be kicking from the 20-yard line when they do, which should ensure.
Yeah, unsportsmanlike conduct on the white team after the touchdown. 15-yard penalty will be assessed on the kickoff.
Well, now that Lou Holtz and Notre Dame is going to get that kind of field position, they have got to do something with it, as you see Lou talking right there to his quarterback, Ron Paulus. They have got to get points out of this possession against the Colorado defense.
And Voskovichian to attempt the point after. And it is good. And so Colorado has moved on top of Notre Dame by a score of 10-0, 5:55 left in the first. Back to the kickoff. Fourier, who just scored the touchdown, Crespi High School, that's in the Valley. We talked to him, and he said that we were asking him, of course you know this because you went there, about the size of the school. He said, we were so small. You got the big bands here? He said, we didn't have a band. We had a boom box in the back of a pickup truck that would drive around the field.
I guess I'm dating myself, but they couldn't afford the boom box when I was there.
All right, we're set to go. Voskovichian will kick it off for the Buffaloes. Now again, because of the penalty for the celebration, kicking from the 20. And here is Emmett Mosley on the return, and he hands off to Scott Solomon. Solomon around the corner to the 50, 45-yard line of Colorado. So Notre Dame will start with excellent field position, 28 yards on the return. Curtis Musfeld with the tackle.
Well, it tells you a little something about Lou Holtz's approach to this football game, that he is willing to take those kind of chances, not only with an inside screen on the offense to Mosley, taking the chance of a bad handoff on that reverse there, and making his special team step to the plate in their last game of this season and contribute. Because special teams, especially the returners, have killed Notre Dame.
So the Irish try to the 46-yard line of Colorado. They're down 10-0. Paulus. Two-step drop, passes drop. He goes to Derek Mays. It was just a little bit low. And it will be shaken down. Chris Hudson, the cornerback, who is the Jim Thorpe Award winner, number 47 for the Buffaloes, had the cover.
The key here really is the throw by Paulus. But let's be honest, Charlie, in a game like this, your quarterback puts the ball that's tipped out there right in your hands, and it looks like a beach ball when it gets there. The timing might be off, but, you know, you got to catch that.
It's second down. Gives off to Beckton. and Becton will go to the 40-yard line. Matt Russell on the tackle.
Well, remember now, Becton was playing in the SC game about 5 weeks ago with that strained abdominal muscle, re-aggravated it in that game, but right now is probably as healthy as he's been at about any time in this season for Notre Dame, and Lou Holtz figures he is the key. He is the man in this running game behind this restructured offensive line.
And he told us he really got fired up at the luncheon a few days ago, that massive kickoff luncheon with 3,000 people that we have here when the Notre Dame band was playing the fight song. And he just may pick up the first down. He needs to get inside the 36-yard line.
A little element of surprise there, Charlie, because Ron Paulus is nowhere near the threat that Cordell Stewart is running the option. Yeah, normally with a fullback, halfback, and Paulus in there, there's only two options, the fullback and the halfback, and Colorado treated it that way, ignored Paulus, and gave Lou Holtz and his Irish a chance to get a first down.
Speaking of Ron Paulus, he told us that his high school coach, George Curwey of Berwick, Pennsylvania, is here today. Now, a lot of high school coaches are here today. But this for a high school coach, his first college game that he has ever seen in person. He's always been out recruiting and always been working and never an opportunity to go to see a college game. And this is his first one. And he just saw Paulus pick up the first down.
Of course, sacks are figured into that minus yardage, but Paulus, if he gets no gain, is usually the best approach for Lou Holtz. That keeps him healthy, keeps him on the ground, lets him pass the ball.
Ray Zeller, the ball carrier. Ted Johnson for the Colorado Buffaloes makes the tackle. And mark it at the 34-yard line.
Now's the time really for the Irish offense to adjust to what they're getting from Colorado. They are getting those reductions from the defensive ends, which is causing a little bit of a mismatch with the offensive tackles and outside linebackers, especially on the pass blocks on the backside.
Robert Farmer comes into the ballgame. He is off on the left wing. And he comes back in motion and a fake to him. Paulus Sips has pressure. He scrambles out to the right. He has the first down. Heads for the sideline. He's bumped out. Good recovery for young Ron Paulus. Derek Mays with a key block downfield, 16 yards for Ted Johnson, bumped him out.
Now there's a case of a quarterback dropping back to pass, seeing the pass rush coming, and there's two words for this performance. Instinct, when you step up, that's instinct. And when you're running for the sideline, you know there's guys after you, there's a little bit of fear in there too. And common sense says, find the out of bounds.
And he does, just outside the 17-yard line. Becton back in. Wallace checks off. And he goes to the first back through, and that's Ray Zeller. And Zellers goes to the 15. He just picks up a couple on the play. One of the things that Lou Holtz told us, and you're seeing that here, is that the offense of Colorado cannot hurt him when they're sitting on the bench. He wants to use the clock. He wants to keep his offense on the field as much as possible.
And you've already seen probably the most important part of that for him, and that is his quarterback, Ron Paulus. Paulus has to mature into a force, not a passer, not a handoff guy, a guy you worry about all three downs. He's got to be an offensive force, and he's got to do it starting with the Irish.
Paulus on the option, and he is wrapped up. Good defensive play by Darius Holland. Holland gave the benediction at the luncheon, and he talked about Coach Mack for a moment and what he has meant and what this means to their group of seniors, and he was a very impressive young man.
He really was, and in that speech, he talked a lot about his coach, and he talked a lot about the game, and coming into the game and doing your game planning. If you're Holland, you're not worried too much about Ron Paulus running that option. And if McCartney had his druthers right now, Ron Paulus would run a lot more options. Holland would make a lot more tackles if they do.
Third down and 11. Paulus to Becton. Becton, a little stutter step, finds his way to about the 12-yard line. Matt Russell with the tackle. It'll be fourth down, and the kicking team will come on for Notre Dame. And we look for Scott Singer, number 12. He should be doing all of the kickoffs, extra points, and field goals. And we mention that because over this year, Notre Dame has used almost half a dozen kickers in both categories.
Notre Dame needs perfect conditions when they kick. They need a perfect snap and a perfect hold, because their kicking has been erratic to pathetic at best.
Charles Stafford is the holder. 29-yard attempt. And it is good. Mark Zadavesky, the snapper, he will only snap. He's been injured, he has been back, and he does it well. Charlie Jones, Randy Cross, and Dan Hicks here at the Fiesta Bowl. Colorado 10, Notre Dame 3. Scott Sinja with the field goal, now kicking off. So a field goal on each side of the ledger. With Troutman and Henry as the deep backs on the return. And it was taken by Troutman. Troutman out to the 20. Hit and just thrown down at the 22-yard line by Kenan Tatum. He just grabbed a fistful of jersey and pulled him down. Now let's go down to Dan Harris.
All right, thank you very much, Charlie. Bill McCartney was very concerned about a couple of his offensive linemen before kickoff began. Tony Birdie and Heath Irwin, a couple of those key cogs on that big offensive front of Colorado, were very sick last night. They had the flu, and they took IV fluids this morning before the game, and it was really kind of touch and go, but both players said, let's give it a shot, and by the looks of the way the offensive line has been working, it doesn't seem to have affected them too much. Charlie?
And here is the give to Rajan Salam as he comes off the right side.
Not only have they not really slowed down, regardless with the flu and the IVs and whatnot, this offensive line has dominated so far the Notre Dame defense. What Notre Dame needs to do is look at this offensive line and see the starts that they have, how many times they play together and starts together every game this year. Unlike the Notre Dame offensive line, it's having a little problems right now adjusting to a little defensive look, a different defensive look in their first start together.
Shalom, 32 yards rushing in 6 carries. And Stewart to throw. Little swing to Shalom, left flat. He heads for the marker, and he is out of bounds. And they're going to step him out right at the 33-yard line, which is the first down marker.
This guy's the whole package, Charlie. This guy won the Heisman Trophy because he rushed for over 2,000 yards, one of only 4 guys to ever do that. And he is a guy that can run. He runs inside. He runs outside. And you see the ability to catch a ball on the run by a running back. Don't underestimate that. That is very, very difficult. And I think it's a sign of a pure, total package of Salam.
First down, 43-yard line. And here's Salam on the right side. Going to pick up a couple to the 35. It'll be second down and 8. We talked to him. He's almost painfully shy. I mean, he's comfortable in a small group, but you get him out. You know, we had him up on the stage at the luncheon. It was almost like pulling teeth, wasn't it? He's not comfortable in that role.
A certain degree of this young man's shyness, I think, is stage shyness. He puts a lot of that on around his peers, around the players and coaches, very loose. In fact, he kind of did a little scam on the media talking about gaining 11, 12 pounds. Turns out he didn't gain anything. Just wanted to relieve some of the hype and attention he's gotten since he won the high school.
Here's the blitz coming. Salam right at the blitz spot. Found the seam, goes to the 40-yard line, makes a nice spin move, and he picks up about 6 on the play. And Justin Goheen makes the tackle. Go ahead.
I'm sorry, Charlie. Nice job by the offensive line of Colorado here. Watch the adjustment with the blitz inside into a quick trap. The offensive line adjusts. Naoli gets a good block at the right guard position. That opens the hole. And what Notre Dame defense has to do, those big guys you're looking at right there, they've got to be stopped. Notre Dame has got to control the line of scrimmage defensively. They haven't gotten close in the first quarter.
And that is the first quarter. After one is in the book, 3 to go. Colorado leads it 10-3. Beside the second period, total offensive first quarter, the Buffaloes 146 yards, long 45 of that, 39 rushing, 6 receiving. Notre Dame had 60 yards. Salam is going to be wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. That was third down and about three. Bert Berry leading the charge for Notre Dame. And so Colorado will have to punt it away.
Notre Dame gave Colorado a little bit different look there, Charlie, with Bert Berry lined up way out on their left side. Berry just collapsed. He was expecting, I think, the option play at him. When he didn't get it, he collapsed right into that play.
So Andy Mitchell will be kicking for the first time. Emmett Mosley of Aurora, Colorado, is the return man. He, by the way, was the state high school player of the year a couple of years ago. It looks in the sun, almost lost it. You can tell from the shadows he was looking directly into the sun. 43 yards on the punt. Let's go down to Dan Hicks.
All right, thank you very much, Charlie. I'm with Rashawn Salaam, the Heisman Trophy winner. His mother, Kalata Salaam Alaji. Now, earlier this week, he told us that you were going to make the decision as to whether he turned pro or not. But it's a little bit different from mom today, isn't it?
I'm going to make a decision. What am I supposed to say?
But a decision, has it been made or has it not been made?
He's supposed to make a decision after this game. That's what I heard. But I don't know if he's actually going to do that or not. But he's supposed to make the decision after the game.
From a mother's perspective, what do you want him to do? You probably want him to go back to school.
No, from a mother's perspective, I think he needs to go on with his professional career.
Well, whatever he does, we wish him the best of luck.
Thank you.
Charlie.
Meanwhile, Ron Paul is scrambling. Then he throws it away. An interesting comment. And by the way, she lives in San Diego, and the announcement is to be made in San Diego, we understand, on Friday. And also, she has the possession of, right now, of the Heisman Trophy. One goes to the school, one goes to the player. And in the middle of February, it's going to be displayed at the San Diego Hall of Champions Museum so they can share it with all their friends in Southern California.
Well, Salaam made the point, talking to us, that, you know, it's up to my mother. I've gone against her wishes my whole life, and lately I've followed her. And she happens to say that it's up to him. And if it's up to Salaam, it's up to Salaam. He is gone. Color him gone to the pro.
And here is Becton. To about the 23-yard line. Looked as if he was stopped after a gain of one or possibly two. Got a couple of more steps. Mike Phillips finally wraps him up for the Buffaloes. The time, 13:45 and counting. That is the time remaining in the first half. Colorado 10, Notre Dame 3.
What this offensive line for Notre Dame has to do is they have to be going forward. They have to be aggressive. They're not a cohesive unit. They're not used to working together. And you've got to stay on your toes and going forward to be successful.
Mike McGlynn in that offensive line now for Notre Dame. Ball slips, comes back, throws underneath the cover. Pass is complete. He goes to the tight end, Oscar McBride. McBride carries about three Colorado players, including Shannon Clavel, and he may just well pick up the first down. And he does.
That was just a case of want to by McBride. McBride actually got the ball about 4 yards short of a first down, and from that point on, it's a matter of dragging defenders, knowing where the first down marker is and getting it. One, two, three, four Buffaloes have a shot at bringing McBride down before he can get to that first down line. He just wouldn't go.
McBride, the senior, 6'5", 260 pounds, only six receptions during the regular season. The first back through, that's Mark Edwards. And he is nailed by Darius Holland, who is simply waiting for him at the line of scrimmage. It'll be second and 10.
And right now, the Notre Dame offensive line is having a hard time adjusting to the things that are happening to them. And the fact that they're getting reductions late, they're getting movement by the defense. See, the defensive ends are reduced all the way down to the offensive guards. I'm sure it's something that Notre Dame didn't practice. It's an inexperienced group. That causes penetration.
Second down and two. Wallace sets up, throws, and just out of the reach of the outstretched Derek Mays. And Chris Hudson had picked him up. That's quite a matchup that we'll have this afternoon between those two players.
And Paulus just puts a little bit too much on this because Mays, he's not clear. Now he's clear. By the time he gets clear inside, that ball is zipped so hard by Paulus. As you see him really firing and stepping up into that throw, Mays just can't get there.
Ball is off to a very slow start, only 3 of 7 for 30 yards through the air.
Remember, this is a quarterback, Charlie, that has thrown for 300 yards less than Salaam has rushed for this season.
And he's throwing here. steps forward, and he's going to be sacked. Right back at the 27-yard line. Clavel and Greg Jones team up on this one. And that is the third sack for Colorado.
Well, Colorado made the comment to us about Paulus's happy feet. What causes happy feet? Happy feet are caused with quick pressure. Watch his feet in the pocket. No time to set up. Doesn't get to set him still. The feet never stop moving. And if a quarterback can't set his feet, a quarterback can't throw.
So Chris Wachtel will be kicking for Notre Dame. Chris Hudson is the returner. Pretty good kick, turns over for him. Chris gets his call for it at the last moment at the 33-yard line. 40 yards on the kick. Colorado leads by 7. Back in a moment.
See this, they didn't tell me about it.
It's
new.
This is OS2 Warp.
This isn't what you're used to using. Word processor,
spreadsheet,
communications program,
personal information manager,
database,
everything you need packaged in.
Cool.
All of those are running right now at the same time.
Multitasking.
So many things.
Record and playback video.
Yeah, I think it obliterates the software I use right now.
Yeah.
OS2 Warp, a totally cool way to run your computer.
1-800-COMPARE. No matter what the other long-distance companies do, it just won't go away. It gives your business the facts and guaranteed competitive prices. Only from AT&T for the life of your business.
95 Air Show Precision Hit.
Now, call for a Domino's pizza and get a full order of wings for $3.99.
The all-new Mercury Mystique drives like no other car in its class. With four-wheel independent suspension, a 16-valve Z-Tech engine that delivers the best highway fuel economy in its class, as well as 14 other features not found on any other car in its class. As for the rest, class dismissed. Drive the all-new Mystique. It's a whole new Mercury.
The IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by the IBM Corporation, by Domino's Pizza. Call now and order new buffalo wings, and we'll deliver them with your pizza. It's gotta be Domino's. By MasterCard. MasterCard, it's more than a credit card. It's smart money. And by Lincoln Mercury and the complete line of 1995 Lincoln and Mercury automobiles.
You're looking down for the MetLife Blimp Snoopy 2. The MetLife Blimp is providing aerial coverage of the Fiesta Bowl for NBC Sports. The MetLife Blimp travels over 60,000 miles a year to cover sporting events and television specials across the country. Colorado will start from the 34-yard line. The last six plays all involved. Rashawn Salah. Jeremy Nau with the tackle.
Look again at a shot at his mother watching him play in the stands, and she said two surprising things just now, Charlie. She said one, that he would make his announcement regarding his future after the game, and she said it was his decision and his really duty as a mother, her duty as a mother, was for him to go pro, for him to continue on with his career in the professional ranks. So this indeed may be his last game. In fact, I think it is.
Here's Stewart in the option, and he keeps around the corner. He can fly. Fastest man on the team, finally bumped out of bounds. The touchdown is saved on the far sideline after a gain of 35 yards.
Much like when you face a boxer who's got a big right hand, Charlie, and the right hand in this case is Rashawn Salaam. You're worried about that right hand, and then the left hand sneaks in and gets you. And Cordell Stewart is that left hand, because when he goes down the line, if you give him a crack, he is gone. Look at the speed. Look at the cup locks as McGee hits the ground. It's what Colorado and their offensive line do best. They move, they get out, and they put people on the ground.
Strong safety, Travis Davis, saves the touchdown. And here's Salam. He's going to lose a couple of yards on the play as he is horse-collared by Ronaldo Wynn. Lou Holtz told us that I'm really glad that we're playing this team on Tuesday, because next year, playing them on Monday, because next year they're all going to be playing on Sunday. They're going to be in the pros or something like that.
There's a lot.
Maybe Tuesday would be better than Monday.
At the rate it's going for the Notre Dame defense, that might be right, because the offensive line is really pushing them around, and that's featuring the skill people of the University of Colorado because of Rashawn Salaam and Cordell Stewart, and Westbrook's got the big play. Savoy's had a big play.
And Stewart has rushed for 64 yards on the option. Now he sets to throw. Goes deep, has it open. It is caught at the 9-yard line. It's Michael Westbrook who pulls it in. John Wooden with the coverage, 22 yards through the air.
And you're seeing the effects of that option play working so well with Cordell Stewart. The play action is sold, a token fake, but it still makes the Notre Dame defense bite. And when they bite, Westbrook heads down the sideline to the perfect position for Stewart just to feed that thing in. Watch the linebackers attack. Safeties attack. Receiver runs a good route. Westbrook's in the right place, and it's just pitch and catch for Stewart and Westbrook.
And it's first down, goal to go, 9-yard line. And here is the option, Stewart. And he keeps, and he is in the end zone with a touchdown. His eighth of the year.
Was the case of a Notre Dame defense so concerned with Salaam on the outside at halfback, they let the quarterback go. Watch as he comes down the line. Just a look, just the threat of the halfback has the defense so concerned that he's able to get, Stewart's able to get for the touchdown. Salaam is just sitting out there, and that implied right hand opened up the left snap.
Oscar Itchen adds the point after. And Colorado moves on top 17-3. Back for the kickoff and the celebration in a moment.
If man were meant to fly, he would have been born with a 32-valve, 280-horsepower Lincoln Mark 8.
Look, it's a gold card. Sure, no card on the planet is more useful, but it can't grant you inner peace. Well, I don't know. I mean, you could use it to go someplace where your only action would be one of non-action, which is pretty peaceful. And if you let Master Guest arrange your vacation, you'd save 20 to 40%, plus another $100 if you book by April 30th. And saving money might be the path of true wisdom. So I guess Gold MasterCard could help you see the light. Just remember to wear your sunscreen. Gold MasterCard, it's more than a gold card, it's smart money. Look for your Gold MasterCard application and apply.
Rauchen verboten.
Boya,
Aber wo er bitte? Tokatisman.
Tabako osuanai de kudasai.
Vietato fumare.
Cigarette man.
Defense fumare. In answer to our passengers' requests, Delta Airlines has become the first and only U.S. airline to fly totally smoke-free worldwide.
Hi, Martin Mull. Let's say I'm one of those franchise motel chains. Same name, maybe, but never two alike. But it's my Uncle Herb. Now, let's say I'm a Red Roof Inn. Well, what do you know? Exactly the same. Because all Red Roof Inns are company-owned, never franchised. So you can count on a great room at a great price every time.
For a great room every time, hit the roof. Red Roof Inns, call 1-800-THE-ROOF.
That's lunch.
Tonight, the movie that launched the best new show on television. If you missed it the first time, now's your chance to see how it all began. ER, the movie, NBC Tonight.
We are truly in the Valley of the Sun, and right now the sun is shining on Bill McCartney, the head coach of Colorado. He told us this is the rubber game. He said, a third time that we have met, we need to defeat Notre Dame to take our program to that level. They have had that level, the high level of excellence for so many years, and that's the standard that we shoot at in Colorado. And here's the return from the three-yard line, Scott Solomon of Notre Dame. Slips a tackle, he's to the 20, inside out move. 30, 35, good return across the 40 to the 41-yard line. 38 yards on the return. DJ Cunningham with the tackle.
You know, we talk about that option play for Colorado being so important, Charlie. On that last touchdown, at the heart of the option play is the quarterback and the halfback, Stewart and Salam. And watch the, what you're going to see is you're going to see the relationship between the quarterback and the halfback. It never changes. Look at that, 3 and 3, 3 yards ahead, 3 yards behind. 3 yards ahead, 3 yards behind. It puts McGee and the entire Irish defense at such a disadvantage, they're not attacking. The key for the option is you have to attack the option. You can't sit and watch it.
Notre Dame from the 41. And here is Beckham, he pops through. He's going to pick up about 9 yards on the play. It'll be second down and one. Ted Johnson with the tackle. Go back to Stewart for just a moment. He already has been involved in 173 yards of total offense. Now 73 yards rushing, 100 yards passing, and look at that. Notre Dame now is 69.
And the reason Notre Dame has been stopped so far offensively is they're taking advantage of confusion and miscommunication along that offensive line, making their first start together.
And Pollard, a little swing into the left flat, and stumbling is Robert Farmer. And he's going to end up losing about 3 or 4 yards on the play. So they'll mark it back at the 47-yard line.
Good timing. Third down and four. Good timing, Charlie. You've got Clevenger out there in front. You have Quist out in front. You have Zellers out in front. And you've got feet that won't stay on the ground together. Because they got together, that's why he ended up on the ground.
Third down and four. And he is going to be shut down. We'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that is going to be at Matt Russell and Shannon Clavel. Meet him in the hole. It'll be fourth down, and Notre Dame will be punting.
Right now, what the Colorado defense has done, Charlie, with their reduction of their defensive ends and clogging up the middle of the Notre Dame offense, they've played right into their own hands. They want to make Notre Dame go outside because they have such excellent defensive speed. Notre Dame has not been able to open the inside running game, and you've got to make them run inside, not outside from the Notre Dame standpoint.
And the punter is Ron Paulus. He kicked some in practice a couple of weeks ago, and then Lou Holtz said no, he didn't think that he wanted it to handle it. Well, now he decided that he does.
He's a designated pooch punter in these situations. Just kind of drill it down and make it die.
And a fair catch is called for. It bounces. The fair catch is off. It'll be down around the 20-yard line. 33 yards on the kick by Ron Paulus. We'll step aside. Back in a moment.
Everything's really responsive. Everything's very fast.
After showing us the live video action while you're running other stuff on internet, it's really seamless.
The real-time video looked just like a television program as far as being able to run different applications all at once. It's pretty impressive. Incredible 3D graphics. You can practically see the expressions on these guys' faces.
It's pretty impressive, especially because it's on a PC rather than some big workstation.
This allows you to do a whole bunch of different things all at once.
That's pretty slick.
OS 2 Warp, a totally cool way to run your computer.
It's only a movie, except on a Sony big screen TV.
Oh, good. Something romantic.
Ahead of you, a dramatic wraparound instrument panel. On your left, a three-person memory system. On your right, a 10-disc JBL audio system framed in burl walnut. Below you, leather, 8-way power seats. And all around you, a car so beautifully designed it can go 100,000 miles between scheduled tune-ups. Lincoln Mark 8. Give up. You're surrounded. Lincoln Mark 8 with the V8 in-tech system. Drive everything else first.
Tonight on an all-new Tonight Show, it's Luciano Pavarotti.
Happy 1995, and according to the Chinese calendar, this is the year of the Neat.
Then Conan's got Chicago Hope's Mandy Patinkin, NBC Tonight.
This is Charlie Jones, Randy Cross, Dan Hicks, the Fiesta Bowl. Colorado leading Notre Dame 17-3.
Bob Davies, the defensive coordinator for Notre Dame, he's making the point to his defense, you better attack these guys from Colorado. Colorado is an excellent full-speed offense, and they're running right at Notre Dame right now.
And the Heisman Trophy winner picks up a couple from the 20 to the 22-yard line. Sean Salam, Justin Goheen wraps him up as we go down to Dan Hicks.
Charlie, thank you very much. I just talked to Bob Davies, the coordinator for the Notre Dame defense. He's sat it down, said don't panic, don't get too excited, but he did say Colorado threw him off a little bit is that they've been coming out more in the one tight end set, two back set, as opposed to the two tight end, one back set that they've been running all season long, and he was always scared of the outside. So it's just going to be a matter of adjustment in that area to get his troops back on track. Charlie?
And here's the one back, but with three wide receivers. All the time in the world, it passes high and good for only a couple of yards. We got a flag drop back at the 15-yard line. Westbrook went up and brought it down. Ivory Covington was there. That is that mismatch that we were talking about earlier in the ballgame. We haven't seen it that often. Now we'll check out the flag.
Personal foul, roughing the passer on the defense.
It happened right there at the end. You saw Cordell Stewart doing the little toe touch, getting himself stretched back out, because watch from the backside as it comes into his legs. Row. Now that will rearrange your spine. That will get your entire body going in the wrong direction.
And the call on Melvin Dansby.
Automatic first down.
And the Buffaloes will have a first down. The ball at their own 38-yard line.
Now that right there is an example of having the wrong part of kind of aggressive play by your defense. You want your defense to attack, not take what really is actually sort of a cheap shot.
And now Colorado with two tight ends, one back, two wide receivers on the near side. And here's the option. And the pick. Well defense. Salam is dropped by Jeremy Sample.
And that really was an example of what I've been talking about, Charlie, is an option play that came out and suddenly Notre Dame had the numbers over Colorado. Stewart and Salam are not by themselves. There are extra defenders. And more importantly, the defenders are attacking. Dansby's in there, Sample's in there, but they're going forward and they're attacking the option point right there. And then there's two or three defenders left. That is what they need to do defensively.
Loss of a couple, second down and 12. And Stewart to throw. And he goes over the middle and the pass is incomplete. So it will be third down and 12. Christian Fourier, the intended receiver, scored a touchdown earlier in the ballgame.
You've seen Paulus throw a pass or two that was just a little bit before the receiver could get at it. In that case, Fourier is just not quite past Goheen when the ball is thrown, and the ball sort of sneaks up on him and gets there quicker.
What did he tell us that after the game he was going to have a small bucket of Gatorade and throw it on himself to celebrate?
Some people celebrate by dumping it on the coach. He wants to dump it on himself.
Third down and 12. George is row. He can scramble. And he's to the 45. Into Notre Dame territory. And along the way, picks up about 15 yards and the first down before Kenan Tatum finally gets him. And it was Salam with a key block that sprung him loose. Four carries, 89 yards rushing for Cordell Stewart, the quarterback of the Buffaloes.
At his speed at 4'3", his size at about 6'3", 210, he really presents a problem for a defense that you're going to see right here. Look at him do the slalom. Little right cut, little left cut, through the gates to the right again, and he gets the first down. He is a guy with that speed and that arm that a defensive coordinator will just lose a lot of sleep over.
Reverse fake option. He wants to go deep back to the side, and it is incomplete. Bill Savoy, the intended receiver, Travis Davis, and Brian McGee picked him up in the secondary. Good coverage for the Irish.
That's a message right there from Colorado that, yeah, we're going to run the option. Yeah, we're going to run the ball on you, but you better not bite when we run that option with your defensive backs. You keep them back there because we'll go deep with that ball off the play action fake.
And Stewart can go deep into the Michigan game, the rocket jet for the touchdown, 64 yards in the air. He has the arm and the speed, no question about it.
Well, according to Rick Neuheisel, his quarterback coach, he has the ability to throw it all over 70 yards in the air.
Second down and 10. Here comes the blitz. He loses it, and he throws it away. It's a play. He stepped away from one defender. There were two in his face. He simply avoided the lot. Heads up play.
Well, what Notre Dame did to him on that play was exactly what Colorado's been doing to Paulus. And that's not give him the opportunity to set his feet. Give him the blitz. Give him the pressure. And look at him go back. He wants to get set. Sample's in his face. He can't set there. I mean, this is a job right there by Notre Dame of attacking a quarterback that wants to move when he wants to, not when you make him do it.
Colorado leading 17-3 with 4:43 left to go. We're in the first half. And here comes the blitz again. This time it's picked up. Good protection. Unloads. Goes deep. It is intercepted at the 1 yard line by
a touchdown.
Is it a touchdown?
James Kidd. The ball went right.
46 yards. Are they going to mark it at the one?
Unbelievable. What a case of concentration.
Oh, wow. It's Brian McGee.
Watch this. 46 yards down to about the 1 foot line. Look at the concentration. Right through the hands of McGee into his hands. Yeah. Wow.
And they're going to mark it down a half a yard from the goal line. Unbelievable. First down, goal to go. And he gets in, and just barely. He's got the touchdown. Oh, but give James Kidd all of the credit for this one.
If you look at that score, you have a subtitle on it. It's speed, Salam, and six. Stewart gets out to the option point, pitches the ball, and then it's all speed into the end zone. Ball just does cover right over the edge of the goal line there and get in for the 6 points.
Richmond with the point out. And it is good. And the Buffaloes move up 24-3.
Lou Holtz of Notre Dame worried about the option, and rightfully so, because with the speed of Colorado, option and success equals 6 points.
Going to the Super Bowl. Boy, that McDonald's Egg McMuffin sure smells good.
95 cents, please.
Yeah, we know. 95 cents for the breakfast bargain.
Bump fresh egg, Canadian stuffed bacon.
Look, just give me 95 cents.
No. You keep yours. We'll get our own there, Colonel Coin Collector.
Break in 95 with McDonald's 95 cent Egg McMuffin. A hot fresh Egg McMuffin or a tempting Big Mac for just 95 cents.
You don't understand. I need 95 cents.
What does she need 95 cents for, Jerry?
Yeah, she's already got Egg McMuffin.
Only through January, so hurry.
What are we, a change machine?
Now is the best time to buy tires at Sears. Through January 7th, save 5 to 20% on all tires. All Goodyear, all Michelin, all Bridgestone, and BF Goodrich. All tires on sale now at Sears Tire and Auto Center.
Craig Lampert isn't too worried about how to invest for Zach's college education. That's because he works with a broker from Dean Witter.
We measure success one investor at a time.
It has a 16-valve Z-Tech engine that delivers the best highway fuel economy in its class. A Micron air filter to remove dust and pollen, as well as 14 other features not found on any other car in its class. Introducing the all-new Mercury Mystique. When we created this car, we pulled out all the stops. The all-new Mystique. It's a whole new Mercury.
Years ago, our family doctor recommended Tylenol, and it's been our family's pain reliever ever since. Nowadays, with all the new products and their claims, just to be on the safe side, I checked back with our doctor. It's good to know he still recommends Tylenol as his first choice for safe and effective pain relief. I trusted Tylenol then, and I trust it now.
Tylenol, the pain reliever doctors recommend and hospitals use most.
You've got the magic touch. Ooh. It makes me glow so much. Ooh. It casts a spell. It rings a bell. The magic touch.
4:07 left to go in the second. 24-3. Buffalo's out in front. Voskirichian will be kicking off for Colorado. Gottsolman is the deep back on the return. And this is going to go in and out of the end zone for the touchback. We'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. Let's go back to the long pass play from Cordell Stewart to James Kidd to the 1-yard line that set up the score.
If Salam truly does go to the pros, they're going to love to see this blocking. Watch Cobbins come up, Grassmanis come around, and look at the job that Salam does blocking. Here comes the blitz. Here comes the stunt. And look at Salam right in the middle, sticks him, and buys his quarterback that extra time to get the ball down the field. Nice throw, just a great catch. And it didn't go unnoticed because Bill McCartney got right in his face as soon as he came to the sideline and told him about it.
Said, you made it happen. All right, Fighting Irish, trailing in the ball game, stands in the 120-yard line. And the reverse. And here is Emmett Mosley. Mosley to the 30, out to about the 34, maybe the 35-yard line. Gave him 15 on the play before Chris Hudson, the Jim Thorpe Award winner, cuts him down. And Ray Zellers had the lead block for Notre Dame.
Well, one of the things you're seeing in this game, Charlie, is a real speed difference between Notre Dame and Colorado. The only real offensive player with serious speed and wiggle is Mosley. And when Lou Holtz and the offense takes their shots and gets the ball in reverses, go to inside screens, he's the man that they're going to use. It won't take Colorado long to adjust to that and start manning up on him.
Wallace deep down the far side, and he overthrows Derek Mays. The receiver will be second and 10. Hudson with the coverage. So you can bring it back to the 35-yard line. Defensively for the Rockies, Shannon Clavell, defensive end number 92, has been a very busy man in the first half. He has a total of 7 tackles and 2 sacks.
And what really he's done for the Buffaloes is get down in a reduced state over the guard, rush over the guard. That's making the guard block him, the tackle block the outside linebacker, and the guard has got absolutely no help because the center's covered. He's getting one-on-one pass block.
Wallace completing only 4 of 9 for 26 yards. He comes out firing again. This one is pulled in the front side by Oscar McBride, the tight end. We've got a flag down.
Another case there, Charlie, of getting the ball out quick to McBride and letting McBride just use that big body with his size and get that first down all by himself at 6'5", 260.
Meanwhile, this is a sidebar. Colorado's total offense is just about 200 yards more than Notre Dame, starting this drive 277 to the Irish 76.
we still check out the clock. And that, of course, was starting this drive. He picked up 15 along the way. So he cut a bit off of the margin. Terry Monk is the referee. The officials from the Big East Conference.
We have illegal touching of the forward pass by the offensive team. The tight end was covered up. It'll be a 5-yard penalty plus loss of down.
By being covered up, they mean that there was a man outside him on the line of scrimmage. He was not an eligible receiver.
Right, it was an illegal formation. McBride lined up at the tight end position. That is not McBride's fault. That is not McBride's responsibility. The problem lies with the wide receivers whose job it is to side up on the line, side judge, and get back off the line of scrimmage. That is a mental bust by the wide receiver.
He wants to keep. He's in trouble. He's throwing this one away. Very difficult to roll to your left and then throw as a right-hander. He couldn't get turned around or squared away. Had the pressure. He just took the hit and threw it away. DJ Cunningham had the cover.
What's even harder to do when you're rolling to your left as a right-hander is to get a face full of defenders. Good job down the field by the Buffalo defense. Then you're getting the filling inside from T.J. Cunningham, the safety, just filling right up under the chin of the quarterback. The speed and the coordination of Colorado on both sides of the ball are really confusing Notre Dame.
Chris Hudson is the return man for the Buffalo. And this time Chris Wachter will be punting. Last time it was Ron Paul. And it's terrible. He shanks it out. It's going to be what? Maybe 8 or 9 yards. And the albatross of the punting game continues to hang around the throat of Lou Holtz.
You wonder why Lou Holtz has his starting quarterback punting? Enough said.
8 yards. Let's go down to Dan Hicks.
All right, Charlie. Very much. The Irish have had their problems with injuries all season long. As the practices came here to Phoenix, Randy Kinder, Notre Dame's leading rusher, hurt his knee, and you're sitting out today. This has to be awfully tough to watch so far, at least.
Oh, even tougher with the way things are going now. You know, you wish you could do something. And, you know, I'm in a position like this now, but I don't know. It's real hard.
You've heard some of Lou Holtz's halftime locker room talks. What do you think he is going to impress upon this team as they get come out of the second half down by a lot?
I don't expect a tirade or anything from him. He's going to tell us, you know, we know what we have to do. We have to come out and do it, and we'll go in there and make some changes and hopefully we can come out and turn this thing around.
What do you think needs to be changed on offense from your perspective here on the sidelines?
I don't know. I think maybe we came into the game with a little of the wrong attitude, and to go in and talk to ourselves and talk to each other and get this thing going.
All right, Randy, best of luck to Notre Dame in the second half, and good luck on your healing of your knee. Charlie?
All right, second and 10, 38-yard line. The pass was incomplete to Michael Westbrook. And Stewart on the option through the short side. More of a tendency to keep on the option when you're coming to the short side of the field?
I really don't think so. I think maybe last year Cordell Stewart would have had more of a tendency to keep when he goes that way because he had a broken left wrist. He was coming off a broken left wrist, and he really couldn't option and flip that ball very well that way. But when you've got a weapon like Salam behind you, I don't think you ever hesitate to feed it off to him.
Third down and 9. Westbrook in the slot on the right side. He's the favorite target. He's looking right. And he sets. And he goes deep to the right side. And it is caught. And guess what? Michael Brooks. Travis Davis had the cover. First down, Buffaloes converting on 39, picking up 20.
You know, Notre Dame blitzes, and the offensive line for Colorado, using that coordination, picks up the blitz. And you have to be very impressed with the arm of Cordell Stewart and what he's doing. He's touch passing balls into Westbrook, over linebackers, over safeties, into very tight spots. And I think right now you have to say the offensive line is doing a great job, but Cordell Stewart in the quarterback position is putting on a show.
And Westbrook, a good target, 6'4", a 210-pound senior from Detroit.
Mike, three, go!
And here's Salam. tackle's got about 5 yards. I loved it when you were talking to Westbrook, and you asked, because he's such a complete receiver. He's big, he's fast, he's strong. You ask him about his blocking. And he said, I work on it during the game.
I practice it during the game. Well, I got news for Mr. Westbrook, who's going to be highly touted coming into the draft. And one of the first things he's going to learn is having bags shoved into his face as he practices to block, because everybody's got to block in the next level where he's going.
Second down and five. And here's the option. And the key. To about the 2 yard line. John Wooden finally took him out after a gain of 11. But Cardale Stewart, he does not go gently into the night. He kind of brings up the forearm and the shoulder as he takes the defender out with it.
Watch the defenders for Notre Dame hit the ground with the cut blocks. The action by the offensive line of Colorado. That was a case where Notre Dame had that play defense. They had people in the proper position, but with that left side, especially Heath Irwin and Tony Birdie, they just sliced everything down in the way.
Helmet to helmet with Sean Wood. George rushed now for 102 yards in the first half. And here's Salon. Touchdown. His second of the ball.
Came into this game averaging over 13 points per game. The trend continues. This is a running back that's got it all going on. A look at his mother, Colada, there. His first son can run with it. He can catch it. He can block. He can do it all. And right now, Lou Holtz and Bob Davey, his defensive coordinator, can't figure out how to stop it.
Neil Voskarichian will attempt the point after. And it is good. Colorado now moves up 31-3 over the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame with a minute 35 seconds left to go. We're in the first half.
Very simple. Look at the blocking. Contact, contact, and then a one-on-one move and fake out. Laron Cobbins had a shot at Salam, and he can't bring him down. You know, it has to be the most impressive thing about the Colorado performance so far, Charlie. If they're this good, they're this physical, they're this fast, and Salam can score this easy. If you watched it last night and watched Nebraska win here on NBC, how good is Nebraska, who just stoned Colorado and just physically took them apart?
They did. They truly did. All right, Neil Voskarichian is going to be kicking off. This coming weekend, we've got a program note for you, and we will give it to you right after. No, we're going to slip it in right now. Next Saturday, Cleveland-Pittsburgh rematch of what, 3 or 4 weeks ago? That is going to be a great one. And then on Sunday, Miami at San Diego. We'll be talking about those games as the playoffs continue on NBC in the National Football League. Ray Zeller's on the return after close to the 35-yard line. Two excellent ball games. Cleveland-Pittsburgh, we were at that ball game. I like that matchup.
And on that promo, you saw a picture of Vinny Testaverde and Rod Woods in their corner. It's a very good matchup, because how Vinny Testaverde this next time handles the defense of Pittsburgh will determine that game. Fine performance against New England yesterday.
Excellent.
For Vinny.
Yes.
I mean, 2 days ago, but the key is going to be how he handles that defense of Pittsburgh, which will attack him.
Pittsburgh's a good ball club. Here's a little swing. Beckton right side. He's to the 40, 45. 50, slips another tackle, 40-yard line, 35, and then finally is caught from behind by Matt Russell. Derrick Mays with a key block. He rambles for 36 yards. Notre Dame needs a big play to get something going as we move on the one-minute mark of time remaining in the first half.
A little something out of Notre Dame, a little wiggle and a little sparkle. Just a quick flat screen that's set up. Leahy, 72, gets a nice block out there with a cross-body block, and then it's just Beckton the rest of the way.
And here is Beckton again. This time he comes to the right, and he's to the 23-yard line. So he adds 6 to his total. Donnell Leomidi making the tackle from Pago Pago. That was Emmett Mosley. That was Mosley who comes in.
At this situation, though, Charlie, you're not going to scare Colorado with the running game. You've got to put it in the air.
So Mosley is Fiesta now, the tailback, and we've got jumping in offside. Shannon Clavel is the man who jumped. Mosley, of course, had that great ball game against Navy when he came in. The running backs were hurt for Notre Dame, and he scored four touchdowns in that ball game.
Dead ball foul, false start on the offense. It remains second down.
And so Notre Dame hurts themselves again.
Well, let's see who it is that moves in this whole deal. No contact is yet made. Contact is made. That's off. That's no way. That's Clavel.
That's a bad call. That was a bad call.
Checking in.
Little play action fake deep over the middle. He's got 10-yard line. It's Derrick May. He is upended at the 8. It is a first down. It'll be first down goal to go.
Charlie, you saw Paulus step right into that pass and zip it. Almost zipped it by Mays, but Mays flat lays out and gets that one as Notre Dame continues in their hurry up. 25 seconds or so to go.
First down goal to go. A miscue on the exchange from center. The umpire goes down as the officials jump in. The Buffaloes come out with the football, and they have the fumble recovery.
The one player on the offensive line who started every game for the Irish, Dusty Ziegler, miscommunication on the snap, quarterback with his quarterback, Ron Paulus.
And Darius Holland comes out with the football.
Have a fumble snap recovered by the offensive team. It'll be second down for Notre Dame and their second timeout.
Joe will go back and take a look at that as Notre Dame retains possession.
Watch the snap. See the center. Ziegler snapped that thing just a little bit late. You saw Paulus starting to back out on that, and Paulus recovers his own fumble.
And when he recovers the fumble, he's down. The play is over at that point. Darius Holland apparently reached in and pulled it away from him. And we have 14 seconds. That is the time remaining in the first half.
Another case of what we've talked about so far in this entire first half, the coordination of the offense for the Irish is just off. And it starts with that offensive line. In that case, it started with the center. Ziegler holds onto it. Everybody else is going. They are just a couple of beats off. And Bill McCartney's offense and defense for Colorado are a couple of bars of the two and ahead of Notre Dame right now.
And they're playing the alma mater as far as the scoreboard is concerned, as Colorado's out in front 31-3 over Notre Dame. And the ball just outside the 7-yard line. He's second down and goal to go.
Well, in this situation with 14 seconds left, Notre Dame's got time for two plays. And if you're looking for the money guy all year long has been Mays out there, number one, Derrick Mays.
He's put away to the top of the screen, wide left. Paulus looked, turned the fade in the corner. He can't get to it. And he was going to Derrick Mays all the way. Hudson had the coverage, and he was right there with him step for step.
You know, and an excellent job by Hudson, too. He's out there, and his job is to prevent this type of a pass. Watch Hudson sort of disrupt the pattern. Doesn't want to get him clean around. Gets a little slip. But that ball is thrown about 3 yards out of bounds.
Third down, goal to go.
But the reason that ball is thrown out of bounds that way is the defense that Hudson put on Mays. He just did not give him the opportunity from a wide receiver to get to the spot where Paulus could get him the ball.
Mays and Champion now split to the left. Same look. Comes back over the middle. Touchdown. Derrick Mays. Paulus set it up beautifully, looking into the left corner, taking the whole secondary with his eyes, then came back over the middle to Derrick Mays for the touchdown.
And we've said the offensive line for the Irish has not done a good job all day. Well, on that play, they did an excellent job of protecting for Paulus, because Paulus could sit back there, he could look, he could have his feet set and step into the throw for six.
Scott St. John to attempt the point after. And it is good. 31-10, Buffaloes.
The impressive thing was the protection, but also watch the patience. Mays goes all the way across the field. Hudson pointing. And Mays never stops. He just runs from one zone into another zone and finds the hole. Watch this. He gets a little bump at the beginning. Comes through. When he comes through past Leamidi, he's wide open, and Paulus knows it.
And for Derek Mays, that is touchdown number 12 on the season. And it comes with 5 seconds left to go in the first half. Colorado now 31, Notre Dame 10.
And a good confidence drive for Notre Dame in their offense, especially from the standpoint of being able to, one, throw the ball, and two, get the big plays. The big play on that drive was a screen pass to Becton, 36 yards on that, got the ball down the field, got it in the scoring position, gives them momentum going into the half.
Scott St. John is going to kick off. Herschel Troutman, number 26, and Lyndon Henry, number 39, the returner. Down the middle, and is going to be covered by Ryan Olsen with 2 seconds left to go in the half.
Yeah, we made the point earlier about Lou Holtz's sort of tongue-in-cheek comments about gee, maybe we don't belong here, and I'll completely agree. And I think what Lou Holtz's mission going in here at halftime is, hey, you know, guys, we have to act, we have to play, we have to come out in the second half like we do belong here. Because in the first half, this Irish team did not belong on the field with Colorado. They were slower. They weren't hitting as quick. They weren't pressing that option. And they really, really put on a poor performance for them.
And remember what he told us, that I have to make sure that our guys think that we can win. And that should wrap up the first half, as Herschel Troutman just kind of rambles down the field for about 25 yards. So at halftime, it is Colorado 31, Notre Dame 10. Now here's Dan Hicks.
All right, Charlie, thank you very much. And with Lou Holtz, you got an awful long way to go in the second half. But how big was that late first half touchdown?
Well, we feel we can move the ball on them. The problem we have is stopping them on third down. You know, they've made an awful lot of big plays. I think we've done a nice job on slum. We're having trouble on the option. We're having trouble on the third down pass. And we just haven't executed as well as we need to on offense.
From an emotional standpoint, Lou, what can you tell these kids down 31-10 at halftime in the locker room?
I'm going to tell them what I believe in my heart. 31 points is not going to win this football game. But we can't hit a pass out on second and one and have a back fall down when he got a 20-yard game. We can't do those. Our kicking game or our defense is going to have to set up one score. Our offense is going to have to get to them. We're going to have to convert on a third down play. If you break it down, we can't come back, and we plan on it.
All right, Lou, we'll see about that in a second. Second half. Charlie?
Hi. Right. He is positive. He is planning on it. And coming up, it's the Prudential Halftime Report with Hannah Storm and Paul McGuire, and they'll have all the bowl scores and highlights. Bob Costa's interview with Tom Osborne and a conversation with Rod Woodson. And so right now, let's move across the country as we go to New York City, and here's Hannah Storm.
Thanks a lot, Charlie. Welcome back to our Prudential Update studio in New York. Coming up, I will be joined by Paul McGuire. We're going to update
for that touchdown. And on the fourth touchdown, this is just pure power. This is the case of Salam going in behind an offensive line, just clearing it out. And when it comes time for Cobbins to try to stop him at the...
Thanks a lot, Charlie. Welcome back to our Prudential Update studio in New York. Coming up, I will be joined by Paul McGuire. We're going to update
for that touchdown. And on the fourth touchdown, this is just pure power. This is the case of Salam going in behind an offensive line, just clearing it out. And when it comes time for Cobbins to try to stop him at the goal line, a quick little nifty move, and he's in for six.
And Notre Dame scored with just a few seconds to go in the first half. And this, of course, is what Bill McCartney said. This scared him. But I'm wondering if it kind of scared him in a nice way, because then he can go in and say, hey, we're not in complete control of this. Keep your concentration, keep your speed, keep your energy, and to keep the ball away from Notre Dame.
Really, with the way his offense is running effectively, the way it's passing the ball effectively, they just don't have to change very much. They have to execute and use the speed advantage they have over Notre Dame. Notre Dame has to come out. If Notre Dame can get the special teams touchdown, if Notre Dame can execute offensively effectively, they can make this a ball game. But I think McCartney and his coaching staff have too many of those S's I was talking about to make this close quick.
And a lot of ifs. for the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame that you just talked about. All right, we're set to go with the second half here at the Fiesta Bowl as the sun is kind of creeping towards the west and the shadows now completely across the field here at Sun Devil Stadium in Tempe, Arizona. And Notre Dame will have the first opportunity to move on offense. Scott Solomon on the return. And he doesn't get that big a return out to about the 17-yard line. Let's take a look at the statistics in the first half.
And remember, when you see these, which should be and are considerably out of whack, that Notre Dame got a big chunk of offense on that last drive before the half. And Coach McCartney made the point. One of the keys to this second half is the pressure on Ron Paulus. And you got Ron Paulus standing back, their feet skitterish, the rush is coming after him. That has been the problem. His offense can move the ball. The problem for Colorado and Bill McCartney is, can the defense once again shut down the offense like he did for most of the first half?
Ray Zellers and Lee Beckton are the running backs. A little play-action fake of Zellers coming up and firing to Mosley. I expect we'll see most of this type of an action here in the third quarter. Notre Dame needs to try and score in a hurry. They cannot linger or they'll be lost.
Well, even with three touchdowns, I still think this offense has to be poised and they have to execute. Watch sort of the, I don't know, the kind of the general fire drill and what the heck's going on. Look at the thing. You got running backs running into linemen and quarterbacks running into running backs, and got to take a deep breath and execute, and don't everybody try to make a big play every time the ball snaps.
Second down, here is Beckton sliding off to the right. And he is going to be stopped shy of the first down. He's still going to be about a yard and a half away as Matt Russell leads the charge for Colorado.
Well, I talked about speed and I talked about strategy as an S. Here's an example of a little S on both sides, a little strength. Ryan Leahy's got his strength. He's pushing on Clavell. Russell gets in there on the tackle at the end, and then all of a sudden there's just more strength in the white jersey than there is in the green jersey, and they get going in the wrong direction.
And of course, in case you were not with us at the beginning of the telecast, Notre Dame coming out in the green jerseys. Lou Holtz told us yesterday he come with slight angel wings. And he's going to need the flapping of the wings in the second half. Back in this ball game, as Wallace tries to scramble on the quarterback sneak for the first down. Needed a yard, maybe a yard and a half, and he's going to pick it up. Ted Johnson there was tough to cover him. Johnson, number 46, a linebacker for the Buffaloes, was a runner-up to the Dick Butkus Award. And his reaction to playing Notre Dame, I thought, was rather interesting. He said, you know, the Notre Dame fans, they are so great and they're everywhere. They deserve a bowl.
Well, that's the main reason he felt they belong in this bowl game. But there's people all around the country who said they didn't. And honestly, in the first half, they played like they didn't belong in this bowl game because physically it was a mismatch.
Here's the ride of Beckton. Beckton out to the 35. Makes a nice move. Picks up another four more yards and the first down as he goes to the 40-yard line. A gain of 12 on the play.
One thing you really can't coach and one thing you can't say, well, gee, it's an automatic, is sort of the mystique of players that play at Notre Dame sort of think they can come back from these kinds of deficits. Linemen make the blocks, receivers make the blocks, running backs figure they can make the extra little cut and the extra little spurt. And it's Colorado's defense's job right now to shut down this offense and have them stop thinking about their chances of coming back.
And here is Beckton. Straight shot up the middle. Has the first down and about eight more yards. 18 on the play. So the quick strike offense of Notre Dame that head coach Bill McCartney of Colorado was talking about at the end of the first half continues here at the start of the second.
Well, Lou Holtz talked about the new offensive line being a real plus, and they were going to come off and smash people in the face. Well, first half, there wasn't much smashing in the face, but right there on that last play, especially Ryan Leahy, 72, did a great job of coming off, getting a key block, and they're opening up holes inside.
And the give is to the first back. Zeller looked as if he was going to be stopped, maybe a yard or a yard and a half, and he is going to pick up the first down as he goes to the 31-yard line. Four first downs in a row.
Zellers has a very patient, tough run here because there is nothing there. Clavell collapses everything coming from the left defensive side, but Zellers keeps the legs going and gets more yards, gets another first down, and right now, these Irish think they can do it.
Checking off.
nothing there. Emmett Mosley, who has been in a couple of three times in the ballgame at tailback, also, of course, there is a wide receiver, primarily to give Lee Becton a bit of a breather. But he can fly. He could be a game breaker for the Fighting Irish.
Well, and what the Irish have adjusted to offensively is that reduction of the Colorado defense. They've got used that reduction to stop Lou Holtz's offense in the first half. They've adjusted the blocking patterns a little bit. And on that last play, Colorado adjusted to the adjustment and got the penetration.
Becton is back in the tailback. Wallace to throw. Looks left. Campbell. And he misses everybody. He was trying to pick out Becton. He's running kind of a little of a swing pattern into the flat and then headed downfield.
Well, this was designed initially to be, I think, a quick little screen pass. You just see the offensive line try their cut box there with Clevenger. Becton's supposed to go out for a little screen, but there is absolutely nothing there. That was nothing more than just a toss away by Ron Paulus.
So it is now third down and nine on a drive that started with high hopes for Notre Dame back at their own 17-yard line. Opening drive of the second half.
This is two down territory for the Irish. Way too far for them to think about a field goal. They've got two downs to get this first down.
Ball is and it is incomplete. Emmett Mosley and a catchable ball.
Oh, he had him wide open. The onus goes on to Ron Paulus in the pass he threw because he had Mosley wide open on the sideline. No excuse not to just deliver this into the numbers and make this kind of a no-brainer so the receiver does not have to even think about this pass.
No, high back and away.
Yeah, I mean, he's wide open. It's Paulus' job to deliver that into the numbers, and he didn't do it.
And it is fourth down and nine. 31-10, you go for it, of course.
And when you go for it, you've thrown once to Mosley already. But Notre Dame's proven time and time again, their guy to go to is Derek Mays. Watch the top of the screen at number one.
Dalton Simmons has man coverage on him. So the middle and the pass is complete. 20-yard line, it will be a first down. Charles Stafford pulls it in for 11 yards on the play, converting on fourth and nine.
Remember the key Bill McCartney talked about getting Paulus pressured and not letting him set his feet on that play. A perfect example of him being able to go back, reverse pivot out. Now watch him set his feet. Very quiet, they're set. He steps into his throw and it's accurate. That's what McCartney doesn't want Ron Paulus to do. They don't want him comfortable.
First down, 20-yard line. And here is Ellers, maybe a yard. Open arms, we're waiting. Excuse me, Lee Becton. Open arms, Kerry Hicks and Ted Johnson just waiting for Becton. And a big bear hug and dropped him at the 19. It'll be second down and nine. Alan Wilburn checks into the defense. Go ahead.
Bill McCartney with that concerned look, and that concerned look is about that quick striking offense you talked about earlier, Charlie. This offense can quick strike quickly. The key for Colorado, get penetration, disrupt the handoff, make a big play.
Sellers backs up his team. Wallace with the option. Not a well-executed option, particularly in light of the way that we have seen Colorado and their option today.
Well, Colorado's option is a Formula One race car. Yes. This thing gets out there, and it gets out there in a hurry. This is a four-cylinder economy car option because there's very little speed, there's very little threat, and Cordell Stewart has such a threat. Ron Paulus has absolutely none as a runner.
And you want to know something? It's also a little guess. Third down and 12. Ball is to throw. Kind of bumps Becton. Backpedals. And to Becton, and he has it, and down the sideline as he struggles and goes out of bounds inside the 10 and has the first down. It'll be first and goal to go. And here Paulus and Becton bumped each other, and Becton kind of stumbled along. Slipped in behind the linebackers and caught the pass.
Well, the Notre Dame offense goes from the theater of the absurd here. Miscommunication, a little bump, a token fake, to a little improv. The improv from Paulus, the dancing from Becton.
14 yards. They mark him out at the 7-yard line, where it is first down, goal to go. They'll go to the full house backfield. First time that we have seen that this afternoon. This is the standard procedure for Notre Dame. Robert Farmer gets the call. And Ted Johnson is there for the Buffaloes. Meanwhile, an opening drive that has taken us to 8:43 and counting. Time remaining here in the third quarter.
If Notre Dame can get a touchdown here, it pulls them into two touchdown range, puts them 14 plays down, 14 points down, and it gives Lou Holtz and his team a real shot, and it puts the pressure on the Colorado offense.
15th play of the drive. They play action fake. Good protection goes incomplete. Leon Wallace, the number two tight end, the intended receiver. So it's going to be third down. It was Alan Wilburn who was putting the pressure on Paulus.
It was an excellent job by the Colorado defense on that play, just by coverage. There wasn't much pressure on Paulus, but the coverage was so good. You saw Paulus kind of shifting his feet around, hopping around, getting those happy feet, had nowhere to go. And at the very end, he's looking, and he knows he's got to get rid of it.
So now, third down goal to go. Back to the standard set. But out of bounds. Hudson was out of bounds when he came down with the interception. So it will be fourth and goal for Notre Dame. Derek Mays, the intended receiver.
Well, what happened on that play is it got to an important third down situation. Ron Paulus goes back to pass. Everyone in this place knows he's going to Derek Mays, especially Hudson. Hudson plays it perfectly as Mays slips to the ground and just can't get it. You saw that foot rushing ever so slightly onto the white of that out of bounds as he went down.
We've got a 23-yard field goal attempt coming, or a fake. It is a fake. And the pass, and it is incomplete. As Charles Stafford, the holder, came up with it, and the pass was too tall for Ray Zeller. Simmons dropped back in the coverage, and following the fake, the Buffaloes will take over.
Watch Zeller's at the wing back coming out for this pass. The ball just slightly overthrown past the fingertips, and what a great burst of emotion and confidence for the Colorado football team stopping that play.
So what do you guys do for a living?
Well, we're musicians.
These graphics are outstanding.
Ooh! Fred, you see the expressions on these guys' faces.
I like that.
What is this?
It's called OS2 Warp.
OS2 Warp is real good at playing games.
As far as compatibility, does it accept any Windows or DOS-based applications?
Yeah.
I could really die pretty quickly if this is
very fast.
This is liquid.
OS2 Warp, a totally cool way to run your computer.
As sure as the sun will rise across America, the families that travel will have one common need: to be safe. So it's no surprise that America's favorite full-size car has also been honored for safety. That's according to Prevention Magazine, which gave LeSabre the Safe Car Achievement Award in the full-size category. Buick LeSabre, the American family, family car.
A study presented at a medical conference shows that for the sore muscles occurring the day after a strenuous workout, Advil provides superior relief to extra-strength Tylenol. For next day soreness, Advil just works better. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
1-800-COMPARE. No matter what the other long-distance companies do, it just won't go away. It gives your business the facts and guaranteed competitive prices. Only from AT&T for the life of your business.
The IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by the IBM Corporation, by Goodyear, number one in tires, by Doritos Tortilla Chip, flavors the way you look at life, and by Buick and your local Buick dealers. Remember Buick, the new symbol for quality in America.
The MetLife Blimp Snoopy 2 is teamed up with NBC Sports to provide you a bird's eye view of the Fiesta Bowl. The Blimp is equipped with a state-of-the-art camera system that provides a unique perspective of this action, which is 1,200 feet below, and the action of number 19, Heisman Trophy winner Rashan Salaam, stopped by Paul Grassmanis.
And he was stopped by Grassmanis because the defense did a good job of stringing that option play out and getting down the line, and Salaam had to slow down so that big defensive tackle could get at him. Key for Colorado here is getting a couple of first downs and reestablishing that advantage they had with the speed and the strategy.
Option runs, 120 yards, others, 47.
Others is Salaam. Option is predominantly Stewart.
And here is Salaam as he cuts back. He's going to get only to the 10-yard line. Salaam wears number 19. When he was a youngster, Eric Dickerson was his running idol. He says it came the same upright style, and Dickerson, of course, wore 29. When he went to La Jolla Country Day, he asked for 29. Well, small school, they didn't have all the jerseys with all the numbers. They said, hey, what about 19? That's what Eric wore at SMU. He said, okay. So he's wearing 19. That's his number.
A very modest day for a gentleman so far that said he was going to get over 150 against the Irish. But offensively, much, much more than modest performance for the Buffalo.
And another key block by Salaam. This is complete. This is Christian Fourier, bringing him down to about the 13-yard line. Right in the first half, Salaam with a key block, and that time it was Grassmanis. This time he picks up the blitzer.
That's one thing Colorado can't afford to do. They can't afford to just start getting in these little contests, these little pushing and shoving contests with Notre Dame, because Notre Dame will take them out of their ball game if they do. A good job you saw right there by Salaam picking up the blitz. Fourier trying to make things happen, but look at the wave of defenders. First one, first two, and the third one gets them.
Andy Mitchell, his second part of the ball game. Not a very good one. Straight up and straight down. And it is taken at the 39-yard line, only 26 yards on the punt. And Notre Dame with excellent field position when we come back.
Concept cars. Those gorgeous cars built for auto shows. Wouldn't it feel great if they built one for you? Someone has. The all-new 1995 Riviera. A new world standard for structural integrity among prestige luxury coupes. Riviera by Buick. The concept car you can drive home. This is Red Dog Beer.
Red Dog.
It's not ice brewed, fire brewed, and it's not some nursing sipping red. It's just genuinely good beer. Okay, there is one thing unusual about Red Dog. It's unusually easy to drink because it's bold yet smooth, because it's made with the finest natural ingredients. Are you gonna like Red Dog? Yeah, we think so. But hey, it's your call.
So I'll meet you under the clock at Union Station.
Wonderful. Bye.
Oh, Allison, how will I know it's you?
I'll be holding a bag of Doritos.
The new bag?
Of course.
I can see it now. Together on the beach with a new bag of Doritos. April in Paris with a new bag of Doritos. Down the aisle with our new bag of Doritos. Me and... Allison?
Back off. He's mine.
Doritos tortilla chips flavors the way you look at life.
MCI presents the AT&T True-False Quiz. True or false? AT&T always saves you money. False. Millions pay. Boy, do they pay.
It just doesn't ring true.
MCI presents the AT&T True-False Quiz. True or false? Every AT&T customer saves with True USA. False. 20 million will save Zippo.
It just doesn't ring true.
Over 100 million people have become fans of ER, but most have never seen the movie that started it all. Tonight is your chance.
Okay, boys and girls, let's go. This isn't a picnic.
Tonight, it's the best new show on television. Now, see how it all began.
Helping them is more important than how we feel.
ER, the movie, 9, 8 Central, NBC tonight.
Notre Dame first down, Colorado 39-yard line. Wallace to throw. Steps forward. He goes deep into the end zone to Derek Mays. And he has it for the touchdown. Whoa! And Randy, you called it when we were away. I would put a camera on number one, Derek Mays. 39 yards, and the score is second of the game.
What Lou Holtz and his offense needed was a big hit. A big play from their best receiver, their best offensive player. As you see, Bob Davey, the defensive coordinator, and Lou Holtz exchange a little high fives. That was a case of Paulus putting it up, but more importantly, that was a case of Derek Mays just going up and wanting it more.
He brought it down. Scott sends your point after. And it's good. It is now 31-17.
Watch the very end of this play as the ball's in the air, pushing in both directions. Hudson pushes and goes down. Mays pushes and stays up. Paul is getting good protection, pressure late, steps up, and cranks her loose. This needed to be about a 60-yard pass. He threw it exactly 60 yards. Right now, the Irish have to be thinking. If he'd have gotten points last time, it'd be 120, but it's 31-7.
What do you do with your computer while you're printing?
When you're faxing?
You have to wait a lot.
Sit there and watch it print?
I read the paper.
File my nails.
Actually...
You don't like waiting?
No.
This is OS2 Warp.
No more waiting.
Word processor, spreadsheet, database, communications.
No, I've never seen anything like this before.
Oh, it's too much.
OS2 Warp, a totally cool way to run your computer.
On average, you drive about 500 hours a year. That's like 21 straight days. Days and nights. And that's the reason for the all-new interior of the new Regal for $19.95. 21 days. In most imports, that could be like a sentence. In the Buick Regal, it's more like a three-week vacation.
Oh, I'm sorry. Sarah's not in right now.
Mom.
Sarah?
Don't say a word.
About what, dear?
I know, it's terrible. Just leave me alone and let me die.
In that case, how about a last meal? McDonald's, maybe? I think that after a Big Mac and some fries, things won't look so bad. And besides, once upon a time, I got the worst due in the world.
Great.
And I was afraid that, well, my boyfriend at the time wouldn't like it.
And the boyfriend was Daddy, and you ended up marrying him.
No, actually, it was a boy I dated before Daddy, and he dumped me.
Thanks, Mom.
So, without that bad hairdo, I would never have met your father, and you wouldn't even be here right now.
That would be perfect.
Trust me, I think that everyone who sees your new do will think, now there's an interesting girl.
Maybe you're right.
Do you mind if we use the drive-thru?
Mom!
He was a college football sensation, a coach with a magic touch. But he was hiding something, and it nearly put him in his grave. The Charlie Pell Story, Dateline Tuesday.
Derek Mays, a Notre Dame record, 11 touchdowns last season. He broke Jack Snow's record. He was 30 years old. He has two touchdowns in this ballgame. And here's the kick, taken by Herschel Troutman. And he is swarmed at the 29-yard line. Let's go down to Dan Hill.
Well, thank you very much, Charlie. I'm with George Curry, Ron Pilas' high school football coach in Berwick, Pennsylvania. This is the very first college game you've attended in person. Tell us why.
Well, we're usually playing in December, Dan, and we wrapped up ourselves in big playoffs, and of course, that's a priority with us. We gotta do our thing first. But I'm very proud of Ron, and I'm just thankful for the opportunity to be here.
Now, the minute you stepped on the field, Ron Pilas threw a touchdown pass. You want to come down to the field more often.
Well, if that's what it takes, I'll stay here the rest of the game. But we're just so proud of Ron. He's done a great job. His numbers were fantastic. We think for a freshman, he's thrown over 20 touchdown passes. And you got to remember, with this offense, Lou Holtz is a team-oriented, ground attack type offense. I mean, his numbers were great. and he's also a redshirted freshman, which he's got three more years. And I think we're only going to see him get better.
Quickly, if you had to give him some coaching talk right now, what would you tell him?
I'd tell him, have Lou run four wide receivers and throw the ball.
All right, you heard it from George Curry. He wants to open up that Notre Dame offense, Charlie.
And right now, it's a Notre Dame defense that makes the big play, led by Brian Hamilton and Oliver Gibson.
Well, what Oliver Gibson and Hamilton do is they get penetration, they break down the blocking patterns, and they do what the Colorado defense was doing in the first half, and that's physically get after the offensive line in front of them.
You're from Los Angeles. Central Catholic, George Curry. He looks like a high school football coach, doesn't he?
He's got yes, sir, written all over.
Yes, he does. Third down and 11. Incomplete. Excellent defensive play by Sean Wooden, who just reached around and batted it away. Meanwhile, the Notre Dame defense has shut down Rashan Salaam, only 10 yards in his last 12 carries.
But watch the end of this play and the anticipation by Wooden. Watch the right hand right there. Excellent pressure on Cordell Stewart as he was throwing it. He delivers it in the perfect spot, but Wooden knocks it down, and Colorado's dealing right now with a fired-up Notre Dame team.
Andy Mitchell, he hangs this one up. Pretty good kick. Fair catch called for and taken back around the 27-yard line by Emmett Mosley. 44 yards on that kick by Andy Mitchell. Remember a moment ago he had one that was, what, about 26, 27 yards, and that set up the drive of Notre Dame. And the Fighting Irish now with a bit more momentum on their side than they have seen throughout this ballgame. They trail 17 to 31, and here they go from their own 28-yard line.
And the key is still going to be, Charlie, the well-being of Ron Paulus, and can he stand back there and throw the ball happily and safely and not have to worry about the pressure and moving around.
Play action fake. Buys time. Sets. He unloads one down the sideline, incomplete to Charles Stafford. Now, we talked about the numbers in the first half. Offensively, completely dominated by Colorado. At one time, they had more than 200 yards in total offense. Second half yardage to this point, with 4.5 minutes to go in the third. Colorado has 6 yards rushing. Notre Dame, a total offense, Notre Dame 117.
And the reason really is, Charlie, that Ron Paulus and his offense are willing to try for the big play, to go for the big shot like he does right here. Looks like a javelin thrower. Puts his whole body into that one. He had Stafford open downfield. He couldn't get it to him.
The last three possessions, last of the first half, first two of this half, able to move to that. Now all of a sudden, the Buffaloes step forward, and it is Ted Johnson who makes the tackle, bringing down Lee Becton. And it's going to be third down and long.
Well, you saw Gibson from Notre Dame getting the penetration last time Colorado had the ball, getting a big play in. Well, exactly the same thing happened right there for the Colorado defense. Their defense stood up, went through the Notre Dame offensive line, gave him a little bit of a look, gave him a blitz, got the penetration, and stopped the run. For Colorado, psychologically and as a team, they need to stop this play right now to stem the momentum of Notre Dame.
Third down and 11. 4 minutes to go in the third. Wallace has pressure and he stops. Ted Johnson gets him. That is the fourth sack of the ball game for Colorado.
The senior linebacker from Carlsbad, California, comes in with a big play for Bill McCartney's defense. Notre Dame had the momentum. Paulus was on a roll throwing it, and the Buffaloes get their fourth sack of the day just by sticking to it. Sticking with the blitz, sticking with the quarterback, making the tackle. Excellent play by Johnson, but a bigger play for his defense.
And for Ted Johnson, he has a total of 13 tackles in the ball game. This Rockwiller is the punter. And Hudson is the return. Good kick. Taken back to the 33, to the 35. A stutter step move. Good defense, flag down, maybe a face mask. 44 yards on the kick. Alan Rossum making the tackle. He's the freshman from Dallas. A couple of yards on the return. We'll check out the flag.
Holding have an illegal block in the back against the return team. The penalty will be assessed from the end of the run, first and 10.
All right, we'll take a look.
Right at the very end. There's the block on McGee, pushing the back. Another little momentum slowdown for Colorado and Bill McCartney, and an add-on for the Notre Dame D.
Next up, the 1995 Air Show's Precision Jet. What a double barrel.
And I thought their pizza was something.
Spectacular in hot, mild, and out barbecue sauce. Call for any pizza and get a full order of our new chicken wings for $3.99.
This is a Goodyear Aqua Tread with a 60,000-mile warranty, and this is a bucket of water. At highway speeds, Goodyear Aqua Tread pumps away over a gallon of water every second, thanks to its deep groove aqua channel. Over a gallon a second, that's 396 gallons per mile. Think about it. The next time it's pouring, buckets. The all-season Aqua Tread, only from Goodyear. We say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
It will not cure the common cold. It cannot erase the deficit. It won't improve your memory or your love life. It's a car. A new car. It's coming soon. It's the new Cavalier. And it's all you need.
Saturday at noon Eastern, the stakes rise in the AFC playoff race. Eric Metcalf and the Cleveland Browns take on their Central Division rivals, the AFC's top-seeded Pittsburgh Steelers. Then next Sunday at 3:30 Eastern, Dan Marino and the Miami Dolphins battle Natron Means and the San Diego Chargers. The AFC Divisional Playoffs next weekend on NBC.
This is Charlie Jones, Randy Cross, Dan Hicks, 24th IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl with 2:58 left to go in the third, and Colorado has the ball. Stewart on the option, and he is going to keep, turns the corner, heads down the sideline to the 50, the 40, and is finally bumped out of bounds by Brian McGee. Oh, what a showcase this ball game has been for the senior from Marrero, Louisiana, Cordell Stewart, as he rambles for 41 more yards.
Well, the offense of Colorado the last two possessions didn't have that swagger, didn't have that confident look. But you know what they did last time there? They put people on the ground. They got the speed out in front. I mean, look, you got an offensive guard, and Naoli, number 65, out there running with his quarterback. That tells you something about the speed. The confidence after that play is back. That's not a bad average, in case you're not a math major.
And Leon Mary with a key block for the Buffaloes. First down, 35-yard line. And here's Salon. That slipped to the outside, dropped to the 32. So he has 3 yards. It's going to be second down and 7. Ryan Hamilton with the tackle.
That option play is so dangerous when they bring it to that open side of the field with the speed they have. When they can get those linemen pulling around and cutting down the linebackers, it takes out the penetration, it takes out the attack, and you see the yardage that that option play can produce.
And Salam has run into a bit of the Fiesta Bowl jinx against Heisman Trophy winners. Only 54 yards in 20 carries thus far. But he still has a quarter plus to go. And here he is to this side. Marcus Allen came in after he won the Heisman Trophy. Did not have that great a ball game against Penn State. Vinny Testaverde, 5 interceptions against Penn State also when he was the holder of the current Heisman.
Well, running backs have had a hard time, and we looked at this before the game and coming in for Heisman Trophy and how's he going to perform in a bowl. But, you know, Salam can't complain about a thing right now because of the gentleman down below him getting 143 yards on 7 carries. That's basically been a physical run 21 times with 54 yards from Salam, and option 7 times down the field for Stewart for the big yard.
Third down. Quick drop, and the pass is good. Phil Savoy, the freshman from the nation's capital, the intended receiver. Alan Rossman had the quick coverage on him.
Stewart just trying to jam this into a very small crack in the defense of Notre Dame. Just barely getting that in. You see how he, the Savoy had to reach just back to that right hip and couldn't adjust physically.
He had only three interceptions during the regular season. One was a Hail Mary in the end zone into the first half against Michigan, and two were tipped. Here's a 48-yard field goal attempt.
This will equal his longest of the year.
Alaskarichian, and he drives it, and he drives it through from 48 yards away.
Well, football is attitude. Kicking is altitude. Watch the ball get up, drives it through from 48 yards, equals his longest of the year, and easily clears it through the uprights.
And the Buffaloes now lead 34-17 with just under 2 minutes left to go here in the third.
Ladies and gentlemen, today's attendance.
Look at Chip. Chip must be a freshman.
That's like, you see the Notre Dame mascot does the push-ups on the field every time they score a point. Well, Chip Sealer, I like Chip. Chip's my kind of guy, because Chip's like me. You get past 20 points, boys, you're doing it without me.
Right. I'm in there for the first field goal, and then you're on your own. Way to go, Chip.
See, but he's the only one to go back to the sideline for a little drink of water or something. Hey, he's been sandbagging us. You can do backflips, you can do push-ups.
And Vance Kirichian will be kicking off. Scott Shulman is the deep back on the return. And it is taken at the 2-yard line. Shulman to the far side. Tumbles a bit at the 15, slips a tackle, and then down around the 21-yard line. Pretty good return. Lyndon Henry, one of the Buffaloes, is the man who brought him down. Be sure to catch the post-game excitement tonight on NBC with Will Smith as the Fresh Prince. Then it's the return of Mommies, followed by the two-hour movie special ER. That's all tonight on NBC. Viewers on the West Coast will see these shows at their regularly scheduled time. Joe spots the ball at the Notre Dame 21-yard line.
And Notre Dame has got some big plays in this first half by going after this Colorado defense. The challenge will be to move the ball conventionally, being patient, and look for the next big play.
Ball is play action. Has pressure. Back pedal, slips away, throws it away, and he gets away with it. There was somebody in the neighborhood. There's no question he was avoiding the loss. Shannon Clavel was the first man to hit him. Darius Holland was chasing him down, and perhaps Ray Zellers was at least in the same area code.
Remember the thing about the feet. Gotta set them, gotta get them set. Those are happy feet. Those are nervous feet. Those are feet pointing at the wrong direction, to the sky. You don't want your quarterback's feet pointing at the sky. Clavel once again putting pressure on Paulus.
Right for Chip to have his feet pointing towards the sky. Second down and 10. Beckton, a hole off the left side. He's out to the 28-yard line. A flag down. Ted Johnson with the tackle.
Offside defense.
We have not had a lot of penalties in the ballgame.
Bob Simmons, the defensive coordinator and assistant head coach for the Buffaloes. Next year taking over the Oklahoma State program. Looking forward to getting to Stillwater, getting that whole thing going. To be honest, he told me he spent most of his time getting ready for that program and getting ready for that next challenge as the new head coach at Oklahoma State. But the challenge right now for his defense is to stuff down Ron Paulus and Notre Dame by aggressively attacking that offense. That's the way they stopped him in the first half, by being aggressive. They can't back off now. They've got to keep attacking the offense.
34-17, Colorado lead. And the give is to the first back through. That's Ray Zellers. He just keeps plowing his way to the 30-yard line. Shannon Clavel and Matt Russell with the tackle. So it'll be third down, about a yard and a half to go for the first down.
Remember the way that Colorado made the big plays against the run earlier in this half and in the first half? By penetration and confusion.
And here is Becton. Ball pops loose. He recovers his own fumble near the 35-yard line, and he's got the first down. Matt Russell knocked it loose. And Dalton Simmons is the injured player. He's a defensive cornerback. And we'll go back and take a look at the play.
And Colorado indeed does attack inside on this play, going with the blitz, going with the slant. Notre Dame adjusts extremely well, brings it backside. You saw Johnson, Ted Johnson got his arm on the ball, caused the fumble. But Becton luckily has that thing roll right out there in front of him when it does hit the ground. Watch it one more time. Fumble is caused right there. Up is a Matt Russell, the other inside linebacker, number 16. The injury is on the backside of the play. Right to the knee.
Ooh,
ouch.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Right there. Dalton Simmons saw the leg whipping around from Matt Russell as he was causing that fumble and hit him right in the side of the knee, the unprotected area of any player's knee.
And Elton Davis will replace Simmons as he is being helped to the sideline. Well, that one hurt all the way up here. Valley of the Sun, as the sun is now setting here in Tempe, Arizona. Isn't that a gorgeous sight? First down, Notre Dame. 24 seconds left in the third. Here's the pitch on the reverse. It's the Solman. He turns the corner, heads down the sideline, and he's going to be just shy of the first down. They're going to mark him out at the 44. Kerry Hicks finally recovered to pin him against the sideline, and he stepped out there. So it'll be second down and one with 16 seconds to go in the third.
Watch Clevenger and Holland, the defensive end and the offensive tackle. Here comes Holland upfield. Clevenger just gets a hand on him. Honestly, holds the heck out of him.
Yes, he does.
Doesn't get called for it, and that's a successful reverse. A gimmick play, if he gets 5 yards, is successful. A gimmick's a halfback pass, a reverse, anything like that. That was a successful play because the defense has to keep thinking about it.
And the give is to the first back. That's the fullback, Ray Jellers. And Jellers should pick up the first down.
Yeah, they needed about a football, and I think they got about a football and two laces on that.
And so they stop the clock, move the chains. Line of scrimmage, the 45-yard line. And they start the clock. And that should wrap it up for three. So the first three are in the book, and we have one to go. Here at the 24th IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl, with Colorado out in front, 34-17.
TV.
It's an all-new Thursday, starting with Mad About You and Paul Wants to Make a Home Movie.
Do it.
Cut, cut, cut. And on Friends, it's Jay Leno. And Morgan Fairchild guest stars as Chandler's mom. And look who she's hitting on.
Uh-oh.
Then, after 5 long years, America's best-kept secret is revealed.
You found out Kramer's first name?
Well, tell us what is it?
You won't believe it.
The cat is out of the bag.
An all-new Seinfeld, followed by an all-new Madman of the People, NBC Thursday.
For as long as there have been neighbors, there have been neighborhoods. And with them came a tradition of people relying on one another. And along with the post office and the grocer, many have come to rely on their neighborhood's 76 station for quality gasolines. The same quality the winning drivers in NASCAR depend on us to provide. And how could we do anything less for our neighbors? 76. Go with the spirit.
don't pay anything till 1996. No down payment, no payments, no interest till 1996. It's the best deal Gardner White has ever offered. Save 25 to 70% on everything. Then pay nothing till 1996. Gardner White's known by the money you keep. And this Wednesday and Thursday, you keep it all till 1996.
Gardner White Furniture. We're known by the money you keep.
You say you watch TV?
Yep, I watch a lot of TV.
Well, then tell me, who's on four?
Who? Well, there's Morton, Carmen, and Seinfeld, and Frasier, and Montel, and Jenny.
Right, now, what's on two?
I don't know, what?
I thought you said you know TV.
I certainly do.
Then where's 50?
I don't know. Where?
On two, and where's two?
I just told you I don't know.
Two's on 62.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I'm so confused.
If the network shuffle has you wondering who's where and what's on, remember, WDIV still has all of your favorites.
Channel 4, who you love.
What you like.
And when you want to watch it.
Now you're talking.
Will he leave his wife for his ex-girlfriend? Next, Jerry Springer.
As we start the fourth quarter, the scoring by quarters, 34-70. Right in the middle of your screen there, that is Dalton Simmons. The preliminary report is two torn ligaments. Not good news. Now let's go down to Dan here.
That is the report, Charlie. Just talked to the trainers, and they were very disappointed to find out that it indeed was an AC and a medial collateral ligament tear. It'll just be a matter of x-rays and whatever they can find out after this game, but he is done for this game with a very serious right knee injury, Charlie.
Meanwhile, Vala scrambles, throws into a crowd, and was it caught? Yes, it was at the 39-yard line. Oscar McBride, 16-yard with Buffaloes, hanging all over him.
What a catch. Ooh. The tight end position has given the Colorado Buffaloes defense problems all year, but here's something you don't expect out of a 6'5", 260-pound receiver, and I'll be honest, that was not a catch. He lands out of bounds with his elbows before his legs come down, I think. Watch the end. His feet aren't down. No, it is. The knee is down when he catches that ball. It was a good call.
39-yard line, Colorado, first down. And ball is to throw. Good protection. Now he steps. Now he throws. Safety valve near side of Sellers. Sellers to the 30-yard line. So they pick up nine. It's going to be second down and one. The margin, 34-17, Notre Dame trail.
You know, Bill McCartney talks about, hey, you got to keep Paulus pressured. You got to make him have those happy feet. Well, Paulus rolls out. He's got the happy feet, but he's able to dump it off to Zellers right in front of the coach. Coach, the defense is doing what you're saying, but they're not quite finishing off the execution part.
Second down and one. Quick set.
Ted Johnson, interception.
Whoa!
He just snares that thing out of the air. What a fabulous play by the senior linebacker. We talked earlier, he's had 13, 14 tackles so far, and easily his biggest play, he just pulls that thing straight out of the air. It was intended for Derek Mays. One more time, and Charlie, watch 46. Anticipate, get into the zone, puts that arm up, and it just kind of snakes right down the inside of his arm and into his chest.
Perfect position, perfect play.
A huge play by a senior playing his last game here for the Colorado Buffaloes. Anticipation, being in the right place, and good hand-eye coordination.
All right, Colorado now will move on offense from their own 33-yard line. With a first down, leading 34-17. Here's Salon to the left side. Trying to take him out of bounds, and that'll stop the clock. I'm surprised that they run that to the short side only because they want to take some time off the clock. From the Buffalo standpoint, let's get this one over. We've got the lead. Let's narrow the chances of the Irish.
Well, they're stringing it. And right now, if I'm Notre Dame, if I see that option again, I attack the quarterback. Much like you saw that Colorado defense celebrating there on the sideline, celebrating the interceptions. But, you know, you've got to attack that option. Attack the quarterback. Make him give it to Salam.
Here is the option to Salam. Salam to the 40, 41-yard line. Gain of 7 yards on the play. First and third down, still a couple to go. Jerry Nau with the tackle, the senior from Hammond, Indiana. And Jeremy Nau was the Notre Dame player who said, I'm anxious to see our offensive line in action. The first time that they really have been healthy and they worked against them in practice, getting ready for the Fiesta Bowl. They'll all be back next year. And he said, it bodes well. We just want to see what they can do in a ball game.
Well, they've had all the work they can handle on the Notre Dame defensive side for this offensive line for Colorado, because this won't be cute time for Colorado. They're going to pound them with their big guy.
Third down and two. Here's the option, and the pitch to Salami throws it in, and he is going to come up a couple of yards shy of the first down. It's going to be fourth down and 1.5.
Charlie, remember what I said. Attack the option, and Bob Davies' defense attacked that option. The first time today, Stewart comes down the line. He's challenged. He flips it out, and when it's attacked, it is stopped. Watch the attack. Jeremy Nau attacks the option point that puts the ball out, and a great job again by Wooden coming in from the corner position and stopping that play.
So Andy Mitchell will be kicking to Emmett Mosley. And it will be touched down at about the 25-yard line. 33 yards on the kick. We'll step aside. We'll be back in a moment.
Be aggressive. Come after him. And if you're Nah, go after the quarterback and think your corner can come in and make the stop. That's exactly what they did.
You are now free to operate all electronic devices.
What a hard-working bunch. And you're working harder than most. I've seen bigger screens on a calculator. Now, this is a nifty screen, but objects may shift during flight. And you're working too hard because, frankly, your hands are just designed wrong. Ooh, an IBM ThinkPad. See, now this is what it's like to fly first class.
Introducing Ford Contour. Gold. A world car for the 21st century. Example. World-class technology in two entirely new engines. The 16-valve Z-Tech that can deliver up to 35 miles per gallon highway and 125 horsepower. Plus, the 24-valve V6 Duratec that travels 100,000 miles between recommended tune-ups. The totally new Ford Contour. Well-equipped for just $14,655.
What's my New Year's resolution? I resolve to eat more pepperoni pizza.
I will eat a bowl of cappuccino chocolate chunk every night.
I love it. My plan? Never say no to a cream sauce.
Here's a resolution for you. Two words. Extra gravy.
Devote myself to peace, love, and burritos. Maybe not in that order, though.
This is my year for meatloaf. With healthy choice, I'll eat what I like.
Meatloaf rules!
The IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by the IBM Corporation, by Healthy Choice Dinners and Entrees, Eat What You Like, by the American Express Corporate Card, and by the totally new Ford Contour, a world car for the 21st century.
We look down from the MetLife blimp cruising above Tempe, Arizona. Snoopy 2 will spend several months traveling the West Coast. He likes the weather. Good choice. Notre Dame from their own 28-yard line, first down. And ball is to throw. Stumbles once to set a screen, and it is dropped. Jumping out behind the screen, a delayed screen, was Ray Zellers. It's incomplete. Darius Holland was putting the pressure on.
And what Darius Holland does is just pressure Pollard. And by pressuring him, what happens, he gets in there so quickly, Paulus can't even semi-set his feet to throw a screen. Now watch Holland 93. You're supposed to slow him down. That's slow as in stop, as in get him out of your quarterback's face. And even a quarterback on a screen needs to step up. The pressure disrupted the timing.
Paulus, 13 of 28, 188 yards, two touchdowns, one interception. Quick drop, has pressure. Rolls away, has more pressure, he is headed to close, and he's in the field.
Colorado is doing the perfect thing with their defensive coordinator, Bob Simmons. He is attacking. He is going after Paulus and saying, look, guys, let's man up down the field. Let's make things happen down there, but let's go after the quarterback. Let's not give him a moment of peace. And a moment of peace for Paulus is a chance stand back there unmolested with his feet solidly on the ground, and the last few plays he hasn't had it. There's Bob Simmons, the defensive coordinator, making the call to this third down play. Same thing, bring the heat.
Third and 10, four-man rush. And he's out of time. And he will be wrapped up by Matt Russell.
And what Matt Russell did, he sort of had a spy blitz. He's back there spying on the running back Zellers, who's back there blocking. And he gets in on Paulus just sort of by default because he's in the right area. An illustration, watch 16, middle of your screen, just spying on the running back, sees the running back blocking. Now he's just acting as that sort of that spy defensive tackle, standing back and waiting for Paulus to sort of come into his arms, and he cooperates.
So Chris Wachter will be kicking. Chris Hudson is the return man. It is three and out for Notre Dame. Just about 11 and a half minutes left to go in the ballgame. Pretty good kick. And it is fielded at the 34, back to the 31. Reverses his field, runs into one of his own players, and he battles his way to the 45-yard line. So Chris Hudson, 11 yards on the return, overcoming all kinds of obstacles. The Wagasee of Notre Dame makes the tackle.
You know, really a highlight for a Notre Dame kicker a lot of times is getting the ball in the air, but there's no rest for you once you kick it. You're still fair game, and you're fair game, and then you're fair game, and you're still fair game, and you're still fair game. Get in that last shot.
The deal of the year on Ford Taurus is now even better because your lease payment is now even lower. Just $237 a month for 24 months on Taurus sedan or wagon. Or you can choose low 2.9% financing or $750 cash back. Don't wait to take advantage of these three great offers on Taurus sedan and wagon, because the deal that makes the best-selling car in America an even greater value ends January 4th. Ford Taurus.
I still enjoy going to work in the morning.
Nothing like that feeling.
It's worth everything.
Owning my own business.
I have your own business.
I enjoy it. I feel strong.
It's a great feeling.
When it's your business, you put your heart and soul into every decision.
I basically dictate my fate.
Confidence. The flexibility that you have.
So consider this one. The corporate card from American Express.
It's me, that's it.
Sign of success.
The card that helps you manage smarter.
Call now and we'll take your application right over the phone.
Now, small businesses save 3% on mobile gasoline.
That's a plus.
And get discounts on car rentals, hotels, and UPS overnight shipping. Accident disability insurance at no extra cost. And detailed monthly and quarterly reports to maintain control.
American Express backs me.
The rewards are wonderful.
See how the corporate card gives you what it gives over a million small businesses. The freedom to do what you do best.
It's easy to apply for the corporate card.
Call 1-800-533-AMEX.
The best card to have.
You'll soon remember why you started your own business in the first place.
You obviously have to love what you're doing.
And action! So when you get that craving for two all-beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions on a sesame seed bun, remember, McDonald's Big Mac is only 95 cents all this month. Cut! Cut! Well, how did I do? Was it okay?
You just caused a major Big Mac attack. Can we move on, Mr. Townsend?
Sure. What's up next?
Egg McMuffin.
Is it 95 cents, too?
Just for this month.
Then we'd better hurry up.
Tonight, Will and Carlton fight the mother of all battles.
Go, let's go. Come
they
on.
Keep going and going.
Now to knock your teeth out. Go ahead. You're in the glass next to my bed. Ah!
Then the mother of all comedies is back.
And so it begins.
All new mommies sneak preview after the Fresh Prince NBC tonight.
Welcome back to the 24th IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl.
Cordell Stewart there with his quarterback coach, Rick Neuheisel. Neuheisel will be the CU coach next year. I tell you what, Cordell Stewart, 311 yards so far offense, passing 168, rushing 143, and lots, if not most of the credit for the development of this quarterback, Cordell Stewart, go to Rick Neuheisel, who will be leading this program after today.
Rashawn Salon across the 50, leans to the 48-yard line. Salon by quarters, 39 yards in the first quarter, 8 in the second, 8 in the third, and now here in the fourth, he has 16.
Salam was one of the people that came out when New Heisel was named head coach, and after or before actually the decision was made, sort of came out polling for New Heisel, saying, you know, part of my decision to stay may go around the fact of whether or not this guy is hired as a head coach, and he indeed was hired.
Salam steps forward. Stuart Heisel, a touch pass, it is not, a flag is down. This one is down the sideline to James Kidd. And there was a marker back at the 38-yard line.
It's going to be holding on the freshman, Ivory Covington. It's taken a while for them to take advantage of Covington, but I believe he had to grab him as he went by. Couldn't quite stop him from catching the ball, but I believe it is going to be defensive pass interference. They didn't go after Covington with Westbrook. They saved it for Kidd. Same result. Big play.
Covington, number 14. He told us he was 5'9". He said, I'm 5'10 and a half and about 160. Well, I don't think he's that big or that tall. Nice young man. This time last year, guess what he was doing? He was at home in Decatur, Georgia, watching the Cotton Bowl game. Notre Dame and Texas A&M. And a year later, here he is.
And holding. Got downfield. You saw him turn the shoulders and hold on to Kidd as he's coming out of that break. He's got the speed. He'll develop the size. You just aren't born with the experience. And this so far has been an experience for Covington.
11-yard line, first down. And here is Salam. He slashes through to the 5-yard line. So he will pick up 6 yards on the play. Oliver Gibson with the tackle. Today's attendance is 73,968, the second largest crowd in IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl history. The largest crowd was in 1989, Notre Dame against West Virginia. Cordell Stewart now 205 yards passing, 143 yards rushing, and the numbers just keep rolling. Cordell Stewart.
And he's got a little bit of that bounce and that swagger back that he had in the first half that he got frustrated out of for a couple times in the first few possessions in the second half.
And here is Long, straight shot into the end zone. His third touchdown of the ball game.
And the way that Colorado controlled the game in the first half and jumped out to the big 21-point lead was physically with their offensive line. That was a case of a 212, 215-pound halfback behind a good blocking offensive line up front, producing the holes. You got to talk about Tony Purdy, Heath Irwin, Brian Stoltenberg, Chris Natoli, and Derek West did the job.
And Boskovichian adds a point after. And the Buffaloes move on down by a score of 41-17. With 9:29 left to go in the ball game, we'll be back for the kickoff.
Let's figure out who this new computer is really for. You or them? All right. This is for you. This is for them. You, them. You, you, them, them. Probably you and them. You, if you get to the computer before they do. Definitely you. Them mostly. You sometimes. Everybody, really. If I talk about how it's built and backed and all that stuff, that won't help, because that's good for both of you. Okay, how is this? It's for everybody, but it lives in your room. You'll work it out.
They were really growing up fast. Too fast. All Kelly talked about was going to high school, and all I could think about was paying for college. Sure, I played around with a few mutual funds, but I was no expert. So I started talking to someone who could help, a broker at Dean Witter.
We must plan for our clients' future as if it were our own.
Funny, kids think their parents always have the right answers. I'm just making sure I do.
We measure success one investor at a time.
Monday. The day we get the world out of bed with a wake-up call of traffic horns, school bells, and factory whistles. And one truck is perfect for a busy day like today. Ford F-Series, with the most powerful diesel pickup engine ever, the convenience of a convertible console seat, and the safety of a standard airbag. More reasons why Ford F-Series is the best-selling truck 17 years running. And that's a lot of Mondays.
Next Saturday at noon Eastern, the stakes rise in the AFC playoff race. Eric Metcalf and the Cleveland Browns take on their Central Division rivals, the AFC's top-seeded Pittsburgh Steelers. Then next Sunday at 3:30 Eastern, Dan Marino and the Miami Dolphins battle Natron Means and the San Diego Chargers. The AFC Divisional Playoffs, next weekend on NBC.
Colorado 41 to 17, 9:29 left. Rashawn Salaam scoring three touchdowns in the ballgame. He's under 100 yards rushing. The only other time this year, that was against Wisconsin. He was under 100 yards. He scored four touchdowns in that ballgame. Meanwhile, here's Scott Solman. And Solman made a bad decision. We'll make a good decision and go down to Dan Hicks.
Thank you, Charlie. I'm with Bill Morrell, Colorado Athletic Director. Interesting situation developed just a little while ago. You interviewed four internal candidates for the head coaching job to replace Bill McCartney. You passed over a seven-year assistant, Bob Simmons, but you went with Rick Neuheisel. Tell us why.
Well, we were really lucky. I think the quality of the assistant coaches on our staff really reflects what we've been able to do over the last 10 or 12 years. Rick Neuheisel is an outstanding young man, did a great job in selling himself, convincing us that he was the guy that should lead this program. And I think as good as we've been, we think we can be better on this.
He seemed to really have a vision for the program when you talked to him.
I think that he does have a good vision. He has a good feel for young people and for kids. And ultimately, that's what these programs are all about, is working with young men and women. And Rick can relate well. That's one of the really good things, the neat things that we liked about him.
Okay, what about the outgoing coach, Bill McCartney? It's been a good 13 years at Colorado football. And any lasting thoughts of Bill?
Well, I don't think that when he came 13 years ago, he realized what a tough job he had ahead of him. But he had a great scheme. He has a great pedigree. He'd been good everywhere he'd been. He just did what he knew how to do, and that's build a great program.
Thanks a lot, Bill. Good luck to the Buffaloes next season as well. Charlie?
All right, it's second down and eight. And here is Fowler on the outside. He's going to keep it down to the 10-yard line. Now, the bad decision that was made by Scott Solman that we mentioned before we went down to Dan Hicks is that he had the opportunity to let the ball go into the end zone. Cover it there, get the touchback, and start from the 20 rather than much deeper in the Irish territory.
And then to kind of compound it, he put his knee on the ground. But take one more look at Rick Neuheisel, who's going to be the new head coach at Colorado after this game. Very youthful, 33 years old. Part of the reason he was hired was that youth and that appeal. But, I mean, he is youthful,
yes.
Youthful.
Yes.
I mean, the main question for me looking at him is not can he coach, is he old enough to drive? And I know he's a good mover. He's a UCLA alum, but gosh, the guy looks youthful.
He is young. All right, here's Powell. Drops it off underneath the coverage. Pass is complete to Zellers. Zellers is at the 25-yard line. And so Notre Dame converts on third down and long as they pick up 16 yards on the play. And we have 7 minutes and 54 seconds left in the ballgame.
When Ron Paulus gets done with this game today, he is going to have an extremely sore arm, because that's all he's used most of the time he's thrown the ball today, has just been his arm. Quarterbacks, they talk about that motion. Rick Neuheisel of Colorado told us about that hip motion that jerks, snaps the arms around, snaps the hips, enables to take the stress off the arm. Paulus has not been able to settle down in the pocket. All he's been able to use is his arm because of the rushing attacking defense.
And here is the pitch to Lee Beckton. Lee Beckton across the 30 out to the 31-yard line. So it will be second down and 5. Let's go back to what you were talking about at the beginning of the ballgame. And that is the difference in the two teams as they come into this Fiesta Bowl. And, of course, as they go out of the Fiesta Bowl. For the Colorado Buffaloes, this is the end of an era. This is the end of the long season. This will wrap up everything that has gone before them. Of course, with the head coach now stepping aside, looking at the new young head coach. For the Fighting Irish at Notre Dame, it's an entirely different story. This is the beginning of next year. And here's the pitch to Beckton as he heads for the corner.
Brad, you got it.
Down at the 36-yard line is Mike Phillips, who makes the tackle. Notre Dame with their offensive line. They have some good freshmen coming in offensively, we understand. But they're starting to build for next year already. This is what Lou Holtz was talking about, because they're going to lose four or five ball players, and four or five very good ball players. But the future is started now, and it starts already this year.
And what he's getting a look at in this Colorado football team he's had tonight is a team that's built itself on speed. They've got the size and they have the speed, something that Lou does not have right now. And
Notre Dame. That speed and the pro prospects on the Colorado team is what has been the biggest difference here. Cordell Stewart, I think, is a pro prospect quarterback. Somebody's got to give this young guy a shot. Westbrook, pro prospect. Salam, pro prospect. Fourier, tight end, pro prospect. That offensive line has two senior tackles. Everybody else is sophomores and juniors. Those guys are pro prospects. This is the guy here in Cordell Stewart. How can you pass a guy up that can rush for over 140 yards and throw for over 200 yards?
And as he told us, he said, I'm a quarterback. I've always been a quarterback. I plan to play quarterback.
He's going to be a quarterback.
Yes.
Here's a guy, especially with Rick Neuheisel coaching him this year, has really matured. Neuheisel highly thought of. In fact, Troy Aikman tried to get him as a quarterback coach at Dallas a couple of years ago. That's how much he thought of Rick Neuheisel from his experience with him at UCLA.
Third down and short, a little quarterback sneak by Paul is trying to pick up the first down. And Kerry Hicks is there to cover him immediately. We may look at the change again. 6:40, that is the time remaining in the ballgame. And Neuheisel talking about Cordell Stewart told us, you know, he said, he's a gym rat. He, you know, he really likes to hang around. He looks at film. He does it on his own. He said, and when he gets to the pros, he'll be able to concentrate on that 24 hours a day. He will just go from level to level to level in a hurry.
Exactly. I mean, that's what's expected out of you in the pros. It's very unusual for a young man to do that when he's in the college game. You see, Notre Dame has got that first down with that sneak. And the key right now for Paulus and the Notre Dame offense is to execute, not turn the ball over, and get the ball down the field with the pass. You've got to throw the ball, especially to your off receiver, because everybody across the country in this stadium and on the Colorado sideline knows that Derek Mays is a guy who wants to get the ball to.
Wallace pump fake, wants to go deep. Nobody is there. That is the sixth sack in the ball game for the Buffaloes. And Shannon Clavel has this one.
That's his third one today. Here's a young man that is just persistent sacks. He's gone after him, gone after him. He's got clean once for a sack. But this defense has just set a Fiesta Bowl record on sacks. A lot of them on persistence because Paulus has had to pump and pump and look. And when he looks and he holds, the feet get happy and the quarterback goes down because the defensive line has done a great job for Colorado.
Second down and 15. And here they come again. And he goes to the quick outlet, and that is Mosley. Mosley across the 40 out to the 42-yard line. Mike Phillips with the tackle.
Don't want to beat this into the ground too much, but watch the feet of Ron Paulus and the fact they can't get set. He ideally is not supposed to be running full speed backwards when he flips that little underneath pass to his off receiver Mosley. And the pressure on that play was coming directly up the inside. I mean, right into his face from Darius Holland.
Third down and 5. Deep down the sideline, and it has caught Derek Mays. Mays pinned against the sideline by Rosga and Chris Hudson. Pulls it in for a gain of 26 yards.
Great matchup all day long. It's been the matchup between Hudson and Mays. Mays, another guy less talked about, but people have been talking about him coming up, not staying for that last year at Notre Dame and going into the pro draft. He's a wide receiver. He's got the speed. He's about, you know, 4'5"-ish or so, but he's 6'2", 6'3", 200 pounds. But watch who gets hit at the end. Watch this. You know who that is? That's Barolt. The athletic director goes down, giving it up for the program.
And here is Ballas, and he's going to go down. That catch a moment ago, Derek Mays. Mays now has 4 receptions for 92 yards and 2 touchdowns.
And on that sack was Kerry Hicks, Darius Holland again getting in there. They covered Clavel, but they forgot about the rest of them. Watch the protection. The feet are moving. There's nowhere to go. And when there's nowhere to go at the last minute, Hicks collapses the pocket on Paulus.
34-yard line. Second down and 12. Pass is complete. He goes very quickly to Charles Stafford. And they're going to mark it just inside the 24-yard line.
That's exactly what Lou Holtz and his offense should do right now for the rest of this game, is get rid of the ball quickly. Don't expose Ron Paulus to any more hits than he really has to take. Let him get it out there. Let him get rid of it quickly. Get the ball into May's hands. Get it into Mosley's. Get it into Stafford's. But don't make him hold it and get hit.
And this time he keeps inside the 20, 15. This was a bad play inside the 10. A little fake and he comes up. The opening is there. He had the possibility of the option, but he never looked back. He wanted it himself.
He's no Cordell Stewart with that 4-3 type 40 speed, but if you're going to completely collapse your defense, completely ignore the quarterback, Ron Paulus is going to take this. He's going to take it and stick it as far as he can get it. Nothing pretty. This is not your exact ballet dancer kind of runner. It's more of kind of a bulldozer, but he'll take it.
6-yard line, first down, goal to go. And nothing is there for Robert Farmer. Paulus very high on Farmer. He said he's really been running tough in practice. He's a good man to have behind me. And he's only a sophomore. So Farmer will be back along with Mark Edwards. Ron Wallace had all sophomore backfield. Now they'll be an all junior backfield next year. Second down and goal.
Was wide open just for that little quick look-in pass from Ron Paulus. Good quick play action fake, and then just used to be the old jump pass where the quarterback could jump up and drill that thing down, but he doesn't even have to jump because there's a window to throw it through. Just straight down and straight into the arms.
-23 with the extra point attempt. Stefan Schroffner will attempt the point after. And it is good for the senior from Honolulu, Hawaii. We step aside. 41-24 Buffalo.
Look, it's a gold card. Sure, no card on the planet is more useful, but it can't grant you inner peace. Well, I don't know. I mean, you could use it to go someplace where your only action would be one of non-action, which is pretty peaceful. And if you let Master Guest arrange your vacation, you'd save 20 to 40%, plus another $100 if you book by April 30th. And saving money might be the path of true wisdom. So I guess a gold MasterCard could help you see the light. Just remember to wear your sunscreen. Gold MasterCard, it's more than a gold card, it's smart money. Look for your gold MasterCard application and apply.
95 Air Show for a signature gift.
Now call for a Domino's pizza and get a full order of wings for $3.99.
My dandruff and itch are awful. I'll try anything. Denorex tingles. Head and Shoulders doesn't.
Both have effective dandruff medicine, but Denorex has something extra that tingles, feels fresh.
That's why I started using Denorex. No flakes, no itch.
Denorex, the serious dandruff shampoo.
The deal of the year on Ford Taurus is now even better because your lease payment is now even lower. Just $237 a month for 24 months on Taurus sedan or wagon. Or you can choose low 2.9% financing or $750 cash back. Don't wait to take advantage of these three great offers on Taurus sedan and wagon, because the deal that makes the best-selling car in America an even greater value ends January 4th. Ford Taurus.
As the sun is setting on the 24th edition of the IBM OS2 Fiesta Bowl, we have 2 minutes and 7 seconds left in the ballgame.
And the sun is also setting on the Colorado Buffalo career. I think of that man right there, Rashawn Salaam.
He just got the Gatorade treatment, didn't he?
The ceremonial splash on the back, farewell present from the boys. I think you put his name in the hat for the NFL draft next year.
Here is the onside kick. Interestingly enough, a fair catch was called for, which, of course, you can do. That was Urshel Traumann. Heads-up call. Fair catch, you got to stay away. He has the ball, as do the Buffaloes. And this is what we were talking about. It happened while we were away.
Here it comes. Hello. That's good. That's refreshing. It's good to see a player get that dumped on him so you can feel how cold I'm sure that is down the back of a coach. The question now, I guess, from the Colorado fans right now is, does Coach Mack get it too before this game's over?
It was Tony Berti and Derek West who were the dump wars. The Heisman Trophy winner, the dumpee, and Coy Detmer is now the quarterback for Colorado. And he kind of fumbled off the snap from center. He said, well, I'll keep it. And he steps forward for a couple of yards to the 47, and Kenan Tatum stops him at that point.
That's sort of the penalty a young guy has to pay if he's going to fumble that snap, is that's going to happen. As soon as you do that, you're fair game for the linebackers and defensive line.
Lou Holtz, the green jerseys and the lucky green cap, did not turn the tide as the Colorado Buffaloes too talented. Too big, too strong, and too fast. What a ball club they have this year. And here is Detmer, and he keeps on the option, and he slips.
That just goes to really illustrate the performance of Colorado today, how good the national champion Nebraska Cornhuskers are. And I know, Charlie, they haven't officially voted for it, but after that game last night, Nebraska has to be the national champion, and Bill McCartney can be very proud of his team and the job that they've done today here in against Notre Dame in the Fiesta Bowl.
Notre Dame takes a timeout, and that gives us a moment to kind of tip our caps to head coach Bill McCartney and the program that he has built. And now he gets the dousing, and that puts the right, really the right spin on the story. It comes to the end of his era, and he took a program that was down and turned it completely around. He said, I want to bring it to the level of the Notre Dame. That's a level of excellence. And this being the rubber game, the third time that they have met, they have split the other two, a win on each side. And there's no question in my mind that he has taken the Colorado program to that upper echelon in NCAA Division I college football.
Well, you know, he got his little Gatorade bath there. It's only the second time that's ever happened to him from his players. The first time was in practice, second time here, and you saw him congratulating and talk to him. And the main reason for what happened today, Cordell Stewart, wonderful performance, and what a great way for Bill McCartney to go out as a Buffalo coach.
And Detmer comes out throwing. The pass is complete to Phil Savoy. And he picks up the first down. Okay, let's keep it rolling. 22 yards. Want me to throw?
He's begging.
I want to throw, yes.
He's begging for passes.
All right. Detmer, during the regular season, completed only 10 of 19. Not a lot of opportunities, but he did throw for two touchdowns, and he had one interception. Now we're going to run. Troutman gets the call, and he goes inside the 30-yard line. And we are inside of 1 minute left to go in this 24th edition of the Fiesta Bowl.
And you talked about, you know, that this is the end of an era, Charlie, for Colorado and the sort of beginning of a new year for Notre Dame. Well, there's a lot of seniors involved in this game, not only for Notre Dame, but also for Colorado, the Foreas, the West, the Birdies. The Stewarts, guys like that that have been around this program the whole time, their whole career under Bill McCartney, and for a lot of people.
Lyndon Henry is the ball carrier. Oliver Gibson with the tackle.
Anything better than a Gatorade bath to a coach nowadays is a trip on the shoulders of your players one more time. Who better to carry him than his tackle? Derek West and his tight end, Christian Fourier, giving him that ride that Lou has to watch.
There have been some great moments in the 17 years that NBC has covered the Fiesta Bowl. Great performances, most of all on the float in the parade with the kids from the Special Olympics waving goodbye. And we wave goodbye. So long.
In a new world, a new standard of excellence, NBC Sports.